Walker from the stretch delivers a strike one pitch. Ground ball to second base. This will do it. Polanco to Casey. Tigers have eliminated the Yankees.
The 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers radio network is on the air.
The Tigers a weekend ago needing one win against the worst team in the American League couldn't get one. After dropping game one in a best of five, they sweep the best team in the American League three straight.
Time now for the Detroit Tigers pregame show. Brought to you by GMAC Financial Services. Call 1-800-32-SMART or online at gmacfs.com. Now, here's Dan Dickerson.
Hello again, everyone, from the Coliseum in Oakland. We're getting ready for the American League Championship Series between the Detroit Tigers and the Oakland A's. The Tigers stunned the baseball world by dispatching the Yankees with authority in four games with two stirring victories in Detroit. And now it's a best-of-seven series with a team they have not faced in the playoffs since 1972 when the American League Championship Series was a best-of-five. Today, the Tigers will send Nate Robertson to the mound in Game 1. Barry Zito has had tremendous success against the Tigers in his career and in the playoffs will get the start for the Oakland A's. Jim will have a preview of this series and a review of that Yankee series with manager Jim Leland right after these words on the Detroit Tigers radio network. Ground ball to second base. This will do it. Polanco to Casey. Tigers have eliminated the Yankees.
Thanks for the love, Detroit fans. And thanks for helping the Tigers advance to the 2006 American League Championship Series. The roar rages on at Tigers.com, the official Major League Online home for Detroit Tigers baseball. Go to Tigers.com to get tickets, get authentic playoff gear, listen live and watch on demand. And yeah, bring on the athletics. Tiger up at Tigers.com.
Crittenden Hospital Medical Center provides complete cardiothoracic surgery and cardiac care that brings world-class health care close to home.
I'm Dr. Frank Basileri, Chief of Cardiothoracic Surgery for the University of Michigan Cardiac Surgery Program at Crittenden Hospital Medical Center in Rochester. Here we have achieved outstanding results for our heart surgery patients. We perform the full spectrum of cardiac surgery, including coronary artery bypass surgery and heart valve repair and replacement.
Hi, I'm Lynn Orfkin, President and CEO of Crittenden Hospital Medical Center. We're proud to have distinguished cardiac surgeons like Dr. Fazilari working at Crittenden. Experienced physicians and advanced technology are all part of delivering the best care, the best outcomes, and the best in quality of life for you and your family. And it's all right here at Crittenden.
For more information about Crittenden Hospital Medical Center, call us today at 248-652-5000 and find out how close world-class health care is to home.
This is the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers radio network. Time now for the Jim Leland Show, brought to you by the Detroit area Chevy dealers. Here's Jim Price.
And welcome back, everybody. Get ready for the game one of the American League Championship Series against the Oakland A's. And Skipper, the great series against the Yankees. We had a couple days off, and you've been through many interviews, press conferences, and now we strap them on and we go get them. How do you feel? How's our team feel?
Well, I think we feel great. I think we're back to work. I think it's probably after the great win at Comerica Park and the great celebration of the fans and everything, I think it's probably best, to be honest with you, that we got on the road and got away from it a little bit, because I think it could that could give you a hangover. And I think that, now we knew we had to get on a plane and get out here and get back to work, and I think we'll be ready to play.
Two ball clubs, pitching, good pitching on both sides of the uniforms here tonight. Our pitching outstanding. Of course, they've been strong with their pitching also. What do you look for tonight against Zito?
Well, Zito's going to be real tough. There's no question about it. Hopefully Nate will be too. This is a series of a meat and potato series. There's not going to be the controversy surrounding this one like there was the last one, maybe. This is a very simple team, the Oakland A's. They're nothing fancy. They just go out, they play the game right, they play it hard, they swing the bats, they pitch. They deserve to be here. They're very capable, in my opinion, of winning the World Series. So we got our hands full. And I think the thing you have to remember, the journey's a little longer now because it's a seven-game series. So, you win game one, you can't get too excited. And if you lose game one, you can't get too down. So we just got to go out and play, Jim, and see how the series unfolds.
Skipper, you told me from day one, our first time we did the manager show, that your guys will be prepared. There's enough preparation for the hitters, for the pitchers, and so on. It's there for them. As we get into the playoffs, does anything change from that standpoint?
No, not really. But I think there's a fine line between enough information and too much. You can't play the game on paper. So you try to give them I try to just separate the information I think is very vital, and I try to keep some of the extra stuff out. It's like a advanced scouting report. Enough information is good. Too much is probably bad. So Dick Egan and the guys did a great job in that Yankee series, and now our advanced scouts were here yesterday to give us some information about this one. And we'll just see how it plays out. But everybody's made contributions, and we've been on a nice little roll here against the Yankee series. But like I said, now it gets a little tougher as it goes on, Jim, and it also gets a little more rewarding.
Nate Robertson, the last time he pitched was in New York. I thought outside of the one inning, he made a couple bad pitches, but the one inning. But coming into this game, confidence-wise for Nate, your feeling?
Well, I think Nate's fine. I think, I think the other thing, Jim, is everybody, when you get in a situation like this, well, who are you pitching? Well, I mean, who do you think we're pitching? We're pitching the same guys that have been pitching all year. I mean, you don't change it now. Like I said, you don't reach in your pocket and come up with Koufax and Gibson at a time like this. So Nate's one of our four. And he's pitching today, and I expect him to pitch us a good ball game.
Jim, you've been with these guys since day one, and I have also. And, you know, their demeanor, the way they handle themselves in the locker room during the regular season and so forth. Do you see anything different? I mean, do you see any fellas that are maybe changed a little bit, getting a little uptight? Is it something you have to watch as a manager?
No, really. I think they're growing up fast. I talked to them about that yesterday. I'm real proud of the way they figured out how this playoff stuff works real quick. They got into it, and, you know, after that disaster at the end of the season. But I think we turned it right around, and they realize how important it is and the importance of each game. And I keep reminding them, you know, in the playoffs, if you win the next game, you're still playing the next day. That's just the way it works. So I just want to keep the concentration. I thought the concentration level was tremendous against the Yankees. Some people are worried about a little bit of a letdown. I really don't believe in that. I think our concentration will be there. I think it's just a matter of whether we're good enough to win four and they're good enough to win three. You know, and if it's vice versa, we go home, and if we win the four, we go on. So I think we'll be ready to play. How it's going to turn out, I have no idea.
We've had our injuries this year, but when you look at the Oakland A's without their keystone combination, missing Harden for most of the year, they've been a very resilient ball club, haven't they?
No, I think Ken Mock has done a magnificent job with his ball club. He's steady. He's like an old shoe. He doesn't panic. He's very comfortable. He knows what he's doing. He's on top of situations. There's nothing fancy about him. Here's mine, let's play yours, and let's see how this turns out. And I can't give him enough credit for the job he's done.
Defensively for them, they have been outstanding. You know, during the regular season, not one of the better hitting clubs, but it was like pitching, and then they found out a way to win a lot of ball games.
Well, there's no question about it. They're a very well balanced club. You know, they catch the ball, they hit the ball with some power, they pitch real good, and like I say, right now they're playing with so much energy. I think Bradley's giving them a lot of energy. You know, a lot of people say he's kind of like a time bomb when they're ready to go off, but this guy's a very talented guy, boy. And, you know, if he gets rolling, he's tough to stop. So the big Hurts playing well for him, swinging the bat good, giving him over the fence power, and, you know, Swisher and Chavez hit the ball out of the ballpark. This is a real good team. There's nothing fluky about this team being here. In fact, in my opinion, I mean, they held off the Angels, who I thought had a really good team with outstanding pitching, maybe lacked a little bit of offense, but they beat a real good team, in my opinion, the California Angels to get here.
Skipper, we came out and worked out yesterday at this time. It seemed like it was a tough shadow time for a ball game. Will that affect either team?
I don't know. There's some glare off the windows out in center field with the sun and all that, and it's going to cool down rather quickly. That's just the way it is out here this time of year. It'll probably be warm when we go off for BP, and by about the 4th or 15th, it'll probably be pretty chilly. So that's just the way it is. And, you know, they got to hit in the same shadows, and they can say that, you know, they're used to it. Well, you know, if you can't see, you can't see. It doesn't matter whether you're used to it or not. So, there'll be no excuses. We got to just go out and play the game.
Skipper, you've been through the playoffs before, but do you find yourself before the game and maybe the night before running different scenarios through your mind?
Oh, sure. You know, you look at things. I had a little bit of a situation with how I was going to hit my order today. I ended up leading Granderson off, and Casey is still third. We didn't do that against Randy Johnson because the numbers were so bad against left-hand pitchers, you know, against him. In Zito's case, the lefties actually hit a little better, higher average. And the other thing was, in this particular case, I like to hit Craig Monroe second in that scenario. And in this case here, Craig's only 2-for-21 with 7 strikeouts against Zito. So I didn't want to put him in that two-hole, so I left it with Granderson and Polanco and Casey.
Skipper, let's go get him.
Okay.
All right, gang, stay with us now. Much more coming up.
on your Detroit Tiger Radio Network.
The Jim Leland Show is sponsored by Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Down by two, top of the ninth, two men on. Time to call on your best pinch hitter. As a facilities manager or a contractor, you may also need last-minute support. For fast backup, call on Grainger. With 24/7 online ordering, tens of thousands of products in stock, and one-stop convenience, you'll have fast access to everything from hardware to safety supplies. Count on Grainger's knowledgeable staff for the right tools and information to drive home a win. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
When you see the blue Old English D, you always think of the Detroit Tigers. And when you see the familiar Blue Cross and Shield, you always think of quality health care. Two great symbols, two great institutions, one great state. The Tigers have been here since 1901, winning games, winning pennants, and winning our hearts. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan has been here since 1939, ensuring that every man, woman, and child in the state of Michigan has access to affordable, quality health care. And like the Tigers, they're here to stay. The Tigers have given the people of Michigan a lot of memorable moments. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan wishes the Tigers all the best in their drive to the championship. Because they believe in the Tigers. Because they believe in Michigan. Because Michigan is their home. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan is a nonprofit corporation and independent licensee of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association.
Time now for the Cut of the Game.
Our Cut of the Game is brought to you by Lady Jane's Haircuts for Men. Visit Lady Jane's in Troy, St. Clair Shores, and Shelby Township. We go back to Game 4, the division series of the New York Yankees. Early in the game, the Tigers set the tone with a couple of home runs in the second. First, it was Maglio Ordonez to give the Tigers a 1-0 lead. And then three batters later, Craig Monroe stepped to the plate with Pudge Rodriguez on first.
Now the 1-1 to Monroe. Fly ball, left field. It's deep to left field. Cabrera at the wall, looking up. It's gone! Two-run shot for Craig Monroe. Tigers lead it 3-0 here in the second.
This is the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network. Now, from the field, brought to you by J.C. Cornelis, building southeastern Michigan one brick at a time. Here's Dan Dickerson.
And joining us on the From the Field report today, we're joined by Tigers starting pitcher Jeremy Bonderman, who closed out that Yankees series with an incredible performance on Saturday. A couple of days ago now, but Jeremy, you've had a chance to kind of sit back, reflect the last couple of days, and I guess why don't we just start with the whole idea of eliminating the Yankees when it seemed like so many people, at least outside of Michigan, didn't think this 95-win team had much of a chance to do that.
A lot of people didn't give us credit, but you got to go out and play, and that's what we did. We went out and played, and we found a way to win. Kenny set a standard as a when he came out and pitched the way he did, and kind of just took those guys and said, I'm not going to back down, I'm coming right at you, and give them everything you got and leave it all in the field. So I went in my start and basically just tried to do the same thing, and I have a little different style, but we kind of both just tried to do everything we could to win those games, and it worked out.
Let's start with the game on Friday with Kenny. I'm sure he heard all the numbers. I'm sure he was very aware of all the numbers. They weren't good against the Yankees. They weren't good in the postseason. It was so dramatic what he did in that game against that lineup. Did you talk at all before the game? And if so, just maybe a little bit about that conversation. Or what were your thoughts as you watched him attack, and I mean attack, that Yankee lineup?
I watched him attack them, and he pitched really well. He challenged guys all game, never backed down, and I think that was a big thing, and that's why he pitched as well as he did. I just had to go out and try and make my pitches and see what happened. But I think more than anything for me, it's knowing that when you dig deep and you have that ability to go get somebody and believe in yourself. When you challenge yourself as a player, I think you can achieve higher things, and I think Kenny did that. And I just kind of fed off what Kenny did, and we had a great two games.
Did he say anything particular to you either after his start or before your start the next day?
No, I don't really talk. I mean, we talked about it, but it wasn't like him and me are two totally different pitchers, so
right.
It's kind of hard for me to get a lot out of what he does, and I just tried to compete. And I from the first pitch on, I let it fly. And
as hard as I could go, for as long as I could go.
Give Tiger fans a feel for what a typical preparation for a game is. I mean, do you go through the opposing lineup batter by batter, or is it more, I've seen these guys, I have a general idea, I have a general idea of what I want to do, and I'm going to see what's working for me this day?
I don't really worry about what, I mean, we have a meeting, and the first day when we played him in New York, and went over hitter. Chuck came to me today with the lineup, told me who was in, who was out, what he thought, and I told him what I thought, and we just see what happens. And that's the way I am out every center. I don't really get caught up in the whole thing, so I just want to go out and pitch my game and have fun.
How much did you said all along, for the last really couple of years, you want to be the number one guy. You want to be the guy that people look to in big games to either stop a streak or to finish a team out like you did last Saturday. How much were you thinking about that to really, really do that on Saturday?
I wouldn't really care, man. I don't care about this whole number one thing. You know, got way out of proportion last year. And our number one's Kenny, Berlander, Nate. And those guys have all proven to be as good as anybody in this game. And I'm just trying to fit in. I'm not trying to be a hero. I'm just trying to be myself and do what I can to help this team win.
When you went through that lineup, and I mean, it's a lineup that's just known for working the counts, getting pitch counts up, and you mowed through it the first five innings, 40 pitches in five innings. How did that happen against a lineup that's usually so good at getting pitch counts up?
I don't know. Luck? I don't know what happened, but I know I was down in the counts. I was getting ahead early. And guys are putting the ball in play, and guys are making great plays behind me. So I just try to just keep going.
Did you get the sense early on it might be a special afternoon? I mean, with the atmosphere, the crowd, the day, and all of that, or just with the stuff that you had?
I knew from the first pitch that I had good stuff, and it was going to be a long day for them, and it was going to be fun for me. And it was a great day for this town, and the teammates, the coaching staff, it's good to see everybody. We have fun and we all get along really well. So it's fun to be able to do that at home and kind of give back to the crowd and stuff. Especially if I lost the last game at home of the regular season, it kind of hurt. But I think we gave them what they wanted. And nobody cares about the last game. We're Champ City now, so
they don't, do they?
we won that series, but this is a big one for us. We got a tough matchup, but I'll take our guys any day of the week.
Real quickly, before we talk about Oakland, just as you were coming off the field right at the end of the game, after your 7 2/3, what was your reaction to the crowd? I mean, I guess you pitched into the ninth, actually. Yeah, the reaction as you came off the mound?
It was awesome. Big crowd. A lot of they showed their appreciation for what I did, and it was very moving. It was one of the best days of my life. So it was very fun.
The Oakland series, now best of seven. This, obviously, these two teams, you look at them, a lot of similarities, the pitching depth and the rotation, the bullpen, the lineups even. Talk a little bit about how you look at this A's team.
They're good. They're a lot like we are. We can pitch, we can hit, we can play defense. They can do all the same things. So it's going to be who's best on any given day is what's going to happen.
I know a lot of people want to make a lot of the fact that you were drafted by the A's and anything along those lines with trying to get back at the A's. What are your thoughts about that, about the whole topic of you being drafted by the A's? Is there always going to be some satisfaction beating them, or are you past that and now you move on?
I don't really care about that anymore. More satisfaction of where we're at. And this is, they gave me an opportunity to play in pro ball and trade me over here, which is one of the best things they're having to me. So, I am where I am. I'm happy to be where I am, and I'm gonna go out and pitch my game. And win or lose, I'm gonna leave it all out there, just like I did in New York versus New York. So I'm just gonna give everything, guy. That's all you can do at this point in the year, in the season, is leave it all on the field.
A lot of Tiger fans, I'm sure, want to know, how does this team? I mean, is this team still riding the high from the Yankees? Is there a letdown after that at all? Just describe what you've noticed the last couple of days as this team prepares for Oakland.
There's no letdown. This team ain't going nowhere. We're gonna fight, and we're gonna do everything we can to win the series. And we're not satisfied. We're hungry. I'm sure the A's are hungry, so it's going to be fun. It's going to be a dog fight. That's the only thing you can ask for.
Jeremy, very memorable moments last weekend, Friday and Saturday, with yourself Saturday, Kenny on Friday. Thoroughly enjoyed watching it. Thanks for your time. We're looking forward to the series.
All right, thank you very much.
Jeremy Bonderman joining us. Stay with us. We've got more coming up after this on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
Players and coaches appearing on From the Field will receive a Bulova watch. Bulova, American-owned since 1875. Available at Maloof Jewelry and Gifts at 11 and a half and Harper in St. Clair Shores.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League titles, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success, your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
It's Esther Sea season, and you know what that means.
Oh, sniffle, 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 sneeze. Sneeze, sniffle, cough. Cough, sniffle, sneeze.
Esther Sea is a vitamin C that gets into your system fast and stays in your system for 24 hours.
Sniffle, sneeze.
So this Esther season, bolster your immune system with the advanced protection of
Esther Sea.
Look for Esther Sea where better vitamins are sold.
This is the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network. Now it's time for the keys to the game. Brought to you by Marty Feldman Chevrolet. Chevy's best. Thanks, Marty. Call them today at 248-348-7000. Here's Dan Dickerson and Jim Price.
Our keys to the game, we look at the pitching matchup. Nate Robertson against Barry Zito. And Jim, Barry Zito, very good in the postseason. Very good in his career against the Tigers. But we saw some quality at-bats from the Tigers all series long against the Yankees. What's the key for the Tigers against Zito?
Well, you know, Zito has all the pitches. We're going to see better pitching in this series by our opponent. There's no question about that. Zito has been pitching terrific. He's had a fastball, but in the high 80s. But if he has the curveball working, that is the key. And remember, he will throw a lot of changeups after the breaking ball. So our hitters are alerted to that already. But he has 3 very good outstanding pitches.
Look at Nate Robertson's starts the last 2 years against the Oakland A's. Really, he's been burned by big innings a couple of different times, especially here in Oakland. What's the key for him against this line?
The last time he pitched here was like, it was like the Twilight Zone. He was shutting them down, and all of a sudden, we couldn't believe what happened. Concentration, I think, on every pitch is so important, especially it gets more important the deeper you go into the season and postseason play. But I don't think there'll be anything that'll bother him coming off that Yankee game in New York, because he only had one bad inning. He made like 3 bad pitches. Other than that, he stayed within himself. You know, he's the bulldog, and we look for quality innings from him to here in this ball game.
Time for our injury report, brought to you by the Detroit Medical Center, the official health care provider of the Detroit Tigers. Everybody healthy, ready to go. It's game 1 of the American League Championship Series, and we've got the starting lineups next here on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
America's number one sports morning show joins Detroit's number one sports station. Mike and Mike in the Morning comes to 1270 XYZ, the sports station. Morning 6 to 10.
Somebody's going to have to come to the table awfully hard to jump into this crew.
Followed by the Sports Inferno with Mike Valenti and Jerry Foster. Middays 10 to 2. The Big Show with Doug Karsh and Art Regner. Afternoons 2 to 6. The Tigers Spotlight with Scott the Gator Anderson. Evenings at 6. Only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
This is the sound of a Cadillac DTS being scanned at over 100 points by a state-of-the-art laser system. The result? Every DTS must pass this final stringent test to ensure its fit and finish measures up to the best in the world. Drive DTS and discover other examples of this relentless search for excellence. Like a powerful North Star V8 engine. Or class-exclusive adaptive remote start, which starts the engine and engages personal driver preferences from nearly 200 feet away. Cadillac DTS. Life, liberty, and the pursuit. Class class claim based on Auto Pacific 2006 large luxury car class.
Test drive a new Cadillac and find out more about our attractive lease or purchase offers. Visit your local Cadillac dealer.
So what do your Discover business card purchase checks do down here in your desk drawer? Basically, show up your other checks. Your checking account checks don't earn rewards, but when you pay vendors with fee-free purchase checks, you earn cashback bonus on business purchases. Plus, you get the same payment grace period as your card. Maybe your purchase checks deserve a drawer of their own.
It's time to take control with the new Discover business card. Visit discoverbiz.com/itworks or call 1-888-DISCOVER to learn more.
The Big Show, afternoons 2 to 6, only on 1270XYZ, the sports station. WXYZ Detroit, our CBS radio station. Five.
He swings a line shot. Base hit, right field, the Tigers win it.
Four.
Home run number 54, central fielder.
Three. Gregory Toth, he got him a strike to end the game.
Two.
He will touch them all.
One.
Tigers baseball is on the air.
Detroit Tigers baseball is brought to you by Comerica Bank, Detroit area Chevy dealers, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan, Murray's Auto Parts Stores, Marty Feldman Chevrolet, Lennox, GMAC, Zuber Buick, Michigan Regional Council of Carpenters, Detroit Medical Center, and the Accident Fund Insurance Company of America. Now live from the ballpark, here's Dan Dickerson and Jim Price.
Sunshine, very pleasant temperatures, a breezy night in Oakland. Hello again, everyone. We are getting ready for Game 1 of the American League Championship Series between the Tigers and the Oakland A's. What a thrill to be here after knocking out the Yankees in four games. Tigers stunning the baseball world with the way they demolished the Yankees in Games 3 and 4. The Oakland A's got here easily as well. A three-game sweep for the Minnesota Twins. And this ballpark, the Coliseum, goes back to the 1960s. It is full tonight. It is electric. It's going to be rowdy, Mr. Price, for Game 1.
Well, they've already showed us how rowdy they're going to be. It was interesting. They introduced the umpires, and all the people, when they would say an umpire, they go, oh, no. I mean, they're really into it out here.
Barry Zito, tough against the Tigers. Very good in the postseason. Terrific start against the Twins in Minnesota. Gets the call for the A's in Game 1. And Jim Leland elected not to make any changes in his rotation. He will also go with the same four that went against the Yankees, starting with Nate Robertson, the 13-game winner. He's pitched well against the A's off and on in his career. He'll get the start for the Tigers tonight. Meeting taking place at home plate. The lineups are being exchanged. We're getting ready for Game 1. Let's take a look at those lineups with Jim.
All right, Dan, they're brought to you by Zuber Buick for Detroit. Leading off and playing center field, Curtis Granderson. At second base and batting second, Placido Polanco. At first base and batting third, Sean Casey. In right field and batting cleanup, Maglio Ordonez. Batting fifth and playing shortstop, Carlos Guillen. Catching and batting sixth, Ivan Rodriguez. Batting seventh and playing left field, Craig Monroe. The DH will bat eighth, Marcus Timms. The batting ninth and playing third base, Brandon Inns. For Oakland, leading off and catching, Jason Kendall. In center field and batting second, Mark Kotze. Batting third and playing right field, Milton Bradley. The DH will be the cleanup batter, Frank Thomas. Batting fifth and playing left field, Jay Payton. Batting sixth and playing third base, Eric Chavez. At first base and batting seventh, Nick Swisher. Batting eighth and playing shortstop, Marco Scudero. And batting ninth and playing second base, D'Angelo Jimenez. And our pitching matchup tonight brought to you by Comcast Digital Cable. Call 1-888-COMCAST today. Nate Robertson making his second career postseason start. Lost the first game in New York. When you look at his numbers this year, career high, 13 wins during the regular season, a 3.84 ERA. Two starts against the A's this year. When you look at those two starts, one in Oakland, one at home. Here, Boy, it was a strange ball game. Seven innings, seven hits, five earned runs. Lost that ball game, then beat the A's in Detroit. Seven innings, five hits, four earned runs. Overall, that 3.84 ERA, outstanding for Nate Robertson. Remember, you talk about Nate and his, we nicknamed him the Bulldog because he will pitch deep in the ball game. He has that good fastball, get up to 92 with the fastball, the slider down and in the right-handers, and of course, the changeup. And here at McAfee Coliseum, well, he's had a tough time. 0-2 with an 8.31 ERA, but he gets the start here. Lifetime 2-2 against the A's, 5.46 ERA. So Nate Robertson doing the pitching for us. Barry Zito, the left-hander. Well, and what can you say about him? Strong in postseason play, 4-2 with a 2.43 ERA. Against the Tigers, 7-5 lifetime with a 2.68 ERA. Did a great job against Minnesota to beat them in postseason play. Eight innings, only four hits, Dan.
Curtis Granderson leads in to start things off. The first pitch is low, and we are underway. Jerry Crawford is our home plate umpire. Hunter Wendelstedt at first. Darryl Cousins at second. Chuck Merriweather at third. There's a strike at the knees and a big cheer from this crowd at the Oakland Coliseum. Gary Cederstrom will work the left field line and Mike Riley the right field line. Zito works quickly, comes right back. The 1-1 is just off the plate to make it 2-1.
The key for him is that breaking ball, the big breaking ball. He has shortened it up at times also, but fastball in the high 80s, low 90s.
Got a big leg kick. Curtis swings and pops it up. Shallow left field, late break for Peyton. Now he comes in, pounds the glove, makes the catch, and there's one out in the first inning.
I think one thing you have to look at what he did this year, 99 walks in 221 innings. That stands out, 151 strikeouts, a batting average against of 257. But those walks, I think if we're a little patient here against him, perhaps we can get some free passes against him in this ballgame.
And we'll watch that early on, Jim, because obviously the Tigers not a team that will walk a lot, but you can, and we've seen it. The Tigers have pushed the pitch count of Barry Zito.
Absolutely.
Even without a lot of walks, the first pitch to Placido Polanco is high and outside. These are a couple of key batters, Granderson and Polanco against the A's. Placido actually hit a little over 500 against the A's this year. He lets a long fly ball that's hooking foul down the left field line. My goodness, that had home run distance about 10 feet foul.
And he's 7 for 11 lifetime off of this left-hander.
Both Granderson and Polanco did a terrific job against the A's pitching this year, and that's the thing that jumps out at you. The Tigers had much more success against the A's pitchers than the A's did against Tigers pitchers. The 1-1 is high and outside, and you'll see that a fair amount. Hitters count and missing high and away with that fastball.
A lot of fastballs up in the zone, and what you try to do is get him to get one about belt high.
2-1 pitch, ground ball wide to third, fielded at a waist-high bounce, bobbled by Chavez, throws to first, and he got him. So two hitters count the first two batters and two easy outs. That's also fairly typical for Barry Zito, the 28-year-old native of Las Vegas, Nevada. Tremendous success, as Jim mentioned, against the Tigers. Thing that's really amazing, Jim, in 14 starts, he's never been knocked out before the sixth, even in games when he's give up runs against the Tigers.
Exactly. It hasn't had his good stuff. He always seems a way to hang around. But that's what the A's are all about.
Works from the third base side of the rubber, takes his arms up over his head, and then he has a big leg kick. He delivers a strike to Sean Casey, one of the few Tigers who's had any measure of success against him other than Placido Polanco.
He's got a home run, 3 for 5, lifetime.
Chavez, the five-time Gold Glove winner, even with the base at third and off the line. Casey takes another pitch. This one is in tight. That evens the count 1-1. We're just underway at McAfee Coliseum in Oakland. They cover up the upper level here at the Coliseum to cut down the capacity, drive up the demand for tickets. There's a strike on the outside corner. That's cut the capacity to 35,000 rowdy fans.
They are rowdy
at the Coliseum.
Well, we talked about the 12-6 curveball. He's also throwing a slider, which we just saw on that pitch.
Now Zito into his motion, the 1-2 to Casey, swing and a little tap foul. He waited on the breaking ball and just got a piece of it to stay alive.
The breaking ball, if the breaking ball starts about belt high, hitters have to try to lay off of it. If it starts higher than that, then it will be a strike. That's how much break it has.
Tigers won the season series from the A's, 5-4, their first series win since 2000. Casey takes the pitch high and outside. He's even the count at 2-2. They played 6 games here, split the 6 games, and then the Tigers took a series from the A's in July in Detroit. But it's been a series dominated by the A's in recent years. Now the windup in the 2-2 pitch. Ground ball, and it's knocked down by Zito. He'll find it, pick it up, throw to first, and the Tigers go 1-2-3. Hit it hard, but he couldn't get it by Zito. Oakland A's bat, bottom of the first, no score. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
Four doors.
Or two.
Four bedrooms.
Or five.
Third car.
Or first boat.
Save for a rainy day.
Or a week in Maui.
Big yard.
Or a short commute.
Sports car.
SUV.
Relocate, remodel, reinvest.
Or reupholster the couch.
Huh?
Decisions, decisions. To take the next step, contact GMAC Financial Services to find out about our auto and home financing and insurance, real estate services, and banking products. Visit GMACFS.com today.
Immunoglobin, Splenus, and my personal favorite, Jejunojejunostomy. Doctors and nurses speak a language all their own. Unfortunately, it has very little to do with English. So my job is to be the translator, to boil it all down to language the rest of us can understand, then put it all up on DMC.org, a website that makes all this very complicated stuff make sense, a website you can actually use and learn from. You can watch streaming videos of actual surgeries and real-life cases bringing medical breakthroughs to life. You can even make an appointment with one of America's best doctors while you're sitting there having your morning trimethylxanthine. That's healthcare speak for coffee.
Join journalist Emery King on the website that makes it all make sense, DMC.org. When you need to know about healthcare, there's no better place to go. DMC.org. The website of the Detroit Medical Center. A better way to get better.
This is Mike Valeni. We talked to Curtis Granderson Tuesdays at noon on the Sports Inferno all playoffs long on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
No score, bottom of the first inning. The Oakland A's getting ready to face the 28-year-old native of Wichita, Kansas, Nate Robertson.
Remember, he was 13-13 during the regular season, ERA of 3.84. Two starts against the A's this season. Won one and he lost one. 14 innings, 12 hits, 9 earned runs. And key thing for Nate, I think, is a pitch ahead in the count. But he pitches ahead in the count, he has better success, but he pitches behind. They average over 300 against him, so very important. Now, against this ball club, who is very patient, he's going to have his work cut out for him. So I think first pitch strikes would be very important for Nate Robertson.
A's offense hasn't changed a lot in recent years, has it? They work the count. It's an organizational philosophy. They had the second most walks of any team in the American League. Actually, one more than the New York Yankees.
Right.
The really reigning king of drawing walks. They don't hit a lot for average. And the home runs, Jim, noticeably down this year. They didn't have quite the extra base power that we've seen in past years from A's teams.
And they have Frank Thomas, too, and he's been really the big guy for them. Just think if he hadn't come here.
Jason Kendall will lead it off, the one-time Pirate. Played for a guy by the name of Jim Leland. There's a strike on the outside corner, sort of the guy in the on-deck circle, Mark Kotze, when he was with the Marlins.
Said his wife's favorite player was Mark Kotze, and still is.
Now the strike one from Nate Robertson, swing and a tap foul. The thing that's interesting, Jim, you go back over the start that Nate Robertson has made the last 2 years against Oakland. It seems like he gets bit by that one big inning, a six-run inning here last year and a three-run home run from Peyton this year in another big inning.
Yeah, it was like, well, how'd that happen? I mean, all of a sudden, it just went by.
Here's a line shot foul past third base coach Ron Washington. Rene Latchman is at first base.
I mean, he was coasting along so good. I mean, you know, setting him down very easily, and then that Peyton home run, it was like a cannon going off.
He's a guy to watch. He had a grand slam off Nate last year, a three-run home run this year. Kendall finished strong. He swings and fouls him back to the screen. Ended up hitting 296 thanks to a 326 average after the All-Star break. This is a guy who basically will slap the ball around. Not really even much extra base power in this bat right now.
No, absolutely not.
But a good leadoff man who'll get on base. The 0-2 pitch again. Line drive past the end in the left field. He'll do that a lot. Sharp line single to lead off for Kendall here in the bottom of the first of a scoreless game.
Well, he read that off-speed pitch. Remember, he's a controlled hitter, uses the whole field. He read that change up and drilled it into left field.
Center fielder, number 21.
65 degrees at game time under sunny skies. Our game time weather conditions brought to you by the Weather Authority, Fox 2 WJBK in Detroit. These are the key bats, these left-handed bats, just because Nate has done such a tremendous job shutting down lefties this year.
181 during the regular season. They gave up some hits to the Yankees when he hung Abreu that breaking ball.
Kotsay at the plate, and he takes a strike. Pudge was setting up outside and actually had to reach back to backhand the ball, but it was a strike. Jerry Crawford goes up with the right hand.
The A's actually hit better against left-handed pitching than right-handed. 264 against left-handed pitching and 258 against right-handed pitching, but many more home runs.
Strike one pitch, swinging a high foul, and you always have to watch the foul balls here at the Coliseum because there is more foul territory here than just about anywhere, and if you compare it to some ballparks, twice as much foul territory.
And we have one of the best at third base hunting them down, so you would think he would be hunting down some foul balls here that maybe other people wouldn't get.
Remains one of the best pitchers' ballpark, and that foul territory is a big part of it because the outfield dimensions are very cozy for hitters. There's a pitch just off the plate, one ball, two strikes on Kotsay. It's 330 down each line, and then you've got a very funky fence.
Very strange.
From
very
left
strange.
To center and from right to center.
Out, in, out, in.
A little flip over to first, and back standing up is Kendall. 367 is where it immediately goes out to. Actually comes into 362, and I can't think of another ballpark where it does that.
No, it's very strange.
The fence is a little higher, and then it goes out to 400 and straightaway center, and basically the same in right. 362 to the power alley. Here's a ground ball to the right side. Polanco has a big hop. He'll flip down to second for the force on Kendall. He takes out Guillen, but there was no chance of doubling up Kotsay. The ball just not hit hard enough. A simple force of Kendall at second. One out, a man on. You will see home runs hit in this ballpark, but again, in general, it helps pitchers. Less runs are scored here and fewer hit fall in because the outfield isn't very big either. It's big in the corners, really.
Yeah, and I was talking to Brandon Inge about the infield. He said it is very, very hard, the infield. And, of course, the Raiders have played here, so certain spots in the outfield are chewed up a little bit also.
Right now, Curtis Granderson is battling a fierce sun that is setting directly behind us. This 5 o'clock start is a little bit tricky for him at the moment. Now pitch high and outside to the switch hitting Milton Bradley, and then in about 15 minutes it's going to get interesting because as we saw yesterday, Jim, during practice, it glares off the windows and straightaway center in those suites and becomes a bear for hitters.
It sure does. It's an interesting time to start a game, and I'm not sure the players are thrilled about it, but there's nothing you can do.
Man on, a man out, scoreless in the first, swing and a miss. Good changeup from Nate. Milton Bradley, 1-for-13 in the series against the Twins. He did hit a very timely home run. Actually, Kendall Kotsay and Bradley didn't do a whole lot in that first series, just 6-for-41 combined. But Milton Bradley turned out to be a pretty valuable player for the A's this
year. No question.
Middle of the infield, still looking for something on the ground. Nate sets the 1-1 pitch, low and outside.
One of the things that the A's will do, though, they led the American League in grounding into double plays with 170, and you know, our guys like ground balls. They can turn them over with the best.
Bonderman, Rogers, Robertson, all very good at inducing that ground ball. Inge is deep and off the line at third. The outfield will play just about straight up. Bradley batting righty against the lefty, Nate Robertson. Swing and a miss. Another good off-speed pitch down and away. And early on, that pitch looks sharp for Nate, even though it's not a strike.
Well, that's the key. You have to let the hitters know, I have all these pitches, even if they're not strikes. You have to put that in their mind, so they have to think. You know what I tell you about thinking, you know, get them thinking, and they think too much, they're in trouble.
Kotsay with a short lead at first. This team does not run a whole lot. Here's a line drive, base hit, pass the diving Brandon Ames in the left field. Kotsay will hold at second, and the A's have a first-inning threat. Another sharp base hit to left field, this time off the bat of Milton Bradley.
Well, that ball was up in the zone. Rodriguez going to go out and talk to Nate about that. That ball was an off-speed pitch and about belt high, and you can see that pitch awfully well when it's about belt high down the heart of the zone.
He's conversing with Nate at the mound. Frank Thomas steps to the plate, and this crowd into it early on because their big bat is standing at home plate. All the offseason acquisitions by Billy being the general manager looked like they were complete flops at the end of April. Loaiza was throwing in the low 80s. Frank Thomas was hitting 180, and Milton Bradley hadn't done a whole lot by the end of April. They all turned out to be very valuable pieces of this team going to the Western Division title.
Big, big part of it.
This guy with a tremendous comeback season. He fouls the first pitch out of play over the screen just to our right. We're perched high above home plate, just to the first base side. But 39 home runs for Frank Thomas, and you can make a very strong case, given the lack of other big bats in this lineup, that he was a MVP in the American League. I don't think there's any question.
I couldn't agree more. In lifetime, one of the few guys has some pretty good numbers against Nate. 3-for-10 with a home run.
Consistent power from the start of May to the end of the season. 114 RBIs, two on, one out, scoreless game, bottom of the first. He swings and lines it to center field. Curtis Granderson going back. He'll make the catch in straightaway center. And Kotze was halfway to third. He retreats to second. He might have been able to make it over to third, but instead he's at second, first and second, two out.
Well, three good swings in this ballgame early for the Oakland A's. That's not a good start. That ball was hit right at Curtis, thank goodness.
Well, here's the big man right here, Jay Payton. Of the 12 runs that Nate Robertson has given up in his two career starts here, Jay Payton has driven home eight of those 12 runs.
Yeah, those bombs that he hit were, because Nate was basically breezing along and like they came out of nowhere.
Grand slam last year, three-run home run this year. Our first inning today brought to you by Cadillac and your Detroit area Cadillac dealers. Big early batter for Nate Robertson. Right-handed batter against the lefty. The first pitch is low and outside, ball one on Payton. Payton does not have the power that he once had. Just 10 home runs. He played full-time, almost 600 at-bats for Jay Payton this year. Hit 296. He's a guy tough to strike out. He's very aggressive at the plate. He does not walk, one of the few A's who doesn't. A 1-0 pitch, swinging a bouncer to second base. Nice big hop for Polanco. He'll step on second, and Nate Robertson gets a big ground ball with two on and two out. The A's threaten, but do not score. We're headed to the second in Oakland. No score on the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
Hi, I'm Paul Precatese, Senior Vice President of Gas Operations for Consumers Energy, encouraging you to call Miss Dig before every digging project. Miss Dig will arrange to have the underground utilities at your home or construction site safely located and clearly marked with colored flags.
Careless digging is dangerous and costly. Call Miss Dig first at 1-800-482-7171. It's fast, it's free, and it's the law.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League pennants, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success. Your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
Comcast, providing all your in-home communication needs. Cable TV, high-speed internet, and their new phone service, Comcast Digital Voice. For details, call 888-COMCAST.
Catch Joel Zamaya Friday at 3 during the playoffs, only on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Tigers bat in the top of the second inning. Dan Dickerson and Jim Price from the Coliseum in Oakland. Good to have you along for game one of the American League Championship Series. The winners of the American League West, the Oakland A's and the Tigers, the wild card team, even though they had a better record than the A's, they start on the road because they were the wild card. A's had another fairly typical season for them. They didn't fall 15 games below 500, but they started slow. 23-29, got above 500. We're still kind of around 500, 100 games in, and then went on just your typical Oakland A's second half run. They do it every year, Jim. 39-14 over a 53-game stretch, and they ran away with the West.
You know, and we kept looking there. It seemed like every other day somebody would get hurt, they would win. Another player would get hurt. I mean, to lose their keystone combination and be without one of their main starters basically all year, it's incredible what they've done.
kudos to Ken Maka, the first cousin of Hal Newhouser, the Tiger great. Here's a pitch high and outside to Maglio, his fourth year. Almost didn't come back. He actually decided to part ways with the A's last year.
Well, you know, he's a former catcher. He's brilliant. He's a terrific guy. And what a job he has done with this ball club.
The 1-0 to Maglio, swing and a miss. Good changeup from Barry Zito. It was a letter from the owner, Lou Wolf, that said that, you know, we just want to express our gratitude, that prompted Ken Maka to pick up the phone and call Billy Bean to express his gratitude. Maglio swings and pops it up foul, and that one will be out of the reach of Swisher. There's an example. It bounced on the dirt warning track, but still
10 feet
at least away from Swisher, who gave it a try, but there's no way he could come close. So he picked up the phone, called Billy Bean. The conversation the next day, they said, well, what about a return? What about you coming back?
Yeah.
After he'd already parted ways, and sure enough, 2 days later, they had a 3-year deal. Here's a pitch in the dirt. And Ken Maka, just one of the nice guys. Of course, he's, I believe, from the state of Pennsylvania.
That's more reason. Well, you know, Jim Leland just praised the job that he has done.
Here's a fastball high and outside. A full count on Ordonez in a scoreless game, second inning. Maglio, not a lot of success against Zito, as we mentioned. Not many do in this Tigers lineup. Right-handed batter against the lefty Zito. The pitch, swing and a foul over the screen just to our right. The Tigers have had actually surprising success given the lack of runs scored. But remember that one year, 0-3 and 0-4, two of the real down years for the Tigers. They were scratching out 1-0 and 2-1 wins over Zito. Here's a ground ball, deep third. Backhanded by the Gold Glover, Chavez throws the first, and he got him. Eric Chavez has been playing with a host of injuries, a very bad hamstring injury. He started favoring it. He started swinging with his arms. He had forearm tendonitis in both arms. And those who watched him all year say this may be his best year defensively. And that's saying a lot for a guy who's won five straight Gold Gloves.
Yeah, Ken Mocker was saying, never complains. He just goes about his business. And I loved his quote when he said, this is probably the least talented team he's ever been with getting the playoffs. And the guy said, what a great tribute. Look what we've done. You know.
Now Carlos Guillen at the plate, and he takes a strike right at the knees on the outside corner. Jerry Crawford goes up with a right hand. Our second inning today brought to you by Bell Tire. Scoreless. Tigers still looking for their first base runner. Barry Zito works quickly. He delivers a breaking ball just off the plate inside. Boy, that's a big bender that looked like it grabbed part of that strike zone.
Yeah, right. He gave up 27 home runs during the year, so he will give up the long ball occasionally, especially with that fastball up in the zone.
Now Guillen takes a fastball high. Tigers are making him throw some pitches here early on. They just have not been able to get a man on. Hitters count for three of the first four batters, but so far all easy outs off the Tigers' bats. The 2-1 pitch to Guillen, swinging a high pop-up. We see it again, playable in foul territory. Swisher, the first baseman, battles the wind, makes the catch. Five up and five down so far against Barry Zito.
Well, we talk about it every game. You don't want them to get comfortable, get into their rhythm. But right now, I think for hitters, favored to the pitchers. And I don't know how many innings it's going to take, but favored to the pitchers are starting at this time of day. There's no doubt about that.
And it's funny, it's not because the mound is in shadow and home plate is in sunshine or vice versa. It's just the background behind the pitcher.
Exactly.
Bright sunshine off the hitter's background and straightaway center in just about 4 minutes. We're going to see a real glare in the batter's eyes off the windows in the football suites in straightaway center. Here's a pitch low and outside to Pudge. 3-for-13 in the first round series against the Yankees. Major fallout from that series.
Oh, boy.
The 1-0 pitch on the outside corner 3 days later, and they're still doing what went wrong with the Yankees stories.
Well, maybe not what went wrong with them, but how good the Tigers have were.
I think that's getting a little bit overlooked.
Exactly.
From the third base side of the rubber, Zito's 1-1 pitch, a strike at the knees, off-speed pitch.
That's that 12-6 curveball. It's one of the best when it's right.
Now Zito has the sign, the 1-2, fastball high, couldn't get Pudge to chase, as many pitchers do, 2-2 on Pudge Rodriguez. Base is empty, two outs, scoreless in the second. The 2-2 pitch, high and outside, and Pudge has worked the count full. Second full count in this inning, Tigers still looking for base runner number one. Zito, arms up over his head, big kick, delivers, ground ball, weakly to short. Scudero charges, easy toss over to first, Pudge is out by half a step. Tigers go 1-2-3 for the second straight inning. A's bat, bottom of the second, no score. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
It begins with a slow dance of turning leaves and crescendos in a trillion trees of flame. For the next several weeks, the curtain rises on the greatest show on earth as the 19 million acres of woods called Michigan slowly explode in a frenzy of color. The show plays along every stretch of highway and coastline in every city and town. Admission is free, and great seats are available everywhere. We can go to the movies this weekend. We can stay home and watch TV. Or we can get up, get out, and go see something we'll remember for the rest of our lives. An entire state in its annual blaze of glory. This show is appropriate for all ages. This show is pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Hi, Michael Lavey, president of Airmaster Heating and Air Conditioning, announcing a very romantic idea. It's Airmaster's new fireplace and grill shop. So now the same people you trust with your heating and air conditioning can give you a romantic gas fireplace that you can turn on instantly with a remote. Imagine turning your living space into a romantic setting with a touch of a button. Are you ready to be romantic? Call Airmaster today, 1-888-9-AIRMASTER.
Welcome back, everybody. My pleasure to tell you about Zoomer Buick. They've been in business downriver for over 20 years. They're family-owned and operated. And if you're looking perhaps for a new Buick or a GM-certified used vehicle, check them out on the web, ZoomerBuick.com. They're quality folks.
Chavez will lead off for the Oakland A's. We're in the bottom of the second inning. A's threatened in the first but could not push across the run with two big bats, Thomas and Payton, retired by Nate Robertson to end that inning. Tigers have gone six up, six down against Barry Zito. Now Chavez, Swisher, and Scudero will face Nate Robertson here in the second inning. Nate Robertson, tremendously consistent for the Tigers this year. Jim, there seemed to be the perception that Tigers' starting pitching faded down the stretch, but it just seemed that it was really the last weekend that
right.
skewed everybody's
it
perception
sure did,
because Nate really was finishing very strong. So was Kenny Rogers until their last starts of the season.
Yeah, Toronto and Kansas City beat us up. I mean, there's no doubt about that. But, well, you know, that team ERA that led the Major League Baseball, I mean, it was just incredible how Nate pitched and Kenny Rogers.
Here's Chavez. The first pitch is a fastball strike. That's a little bit above the belt, but Jerry Crawford goes up with the right hand. Home run in the series against the Minnesota Twins. He struggled at the plate. Not a typical Chavez year. The lowest batting average of his career, and he takes a strike at the knees. Again, the injury-shortened season, or at least an injury-filled
right.
season, I should say, with a hamstring and the forearm tendonitis in both arms have robbed him certainly of some of his effectiveness. Swing and a miss, but only at the plate. And not in the field, which, Jim, I think is a tremendous tribute to the dedication to his job and the importance he puts on his defense.
Well, he realizes that because of the injuries, he's not the offensive player. But, you know, he's been an all-star glove at third base for some time now. We saw it already in this game.
Closed stance, deep in the left-handed batter's box. Nate 0-2 pitch, swinging a bouncer over the mound. Fielded behind second. Nope, under the glove of Carlos Guillen. He was going to field it. He would have thrown him out at first, but there's ball went right under his glove, and it's a base hit, I would assume, for Chavez.
I would think so. Just hit it in the right place, a seeing eye ground ball, and again, the infielders told us this infield very, very hard. That's an example of how hard it is.
That brings up Nick Swisher. Tigers pitchers did a tremendous job holding down A's batters this year. As a team, the Oakland A's hit just 229 against the Tigers pitching. This guy was one of the tough outs. Swisher with a couple of home runs in a game against Justin Verlander. Switch batter batting from the right side, and he takes a pitch high and outside. But the Tigers really did a very good job against some of the biggest bats. It was guys like Kelty and the guy in the on-deck circle, Scudero,
right.
who gave the Tigers the most problems.
Payton. But this fella really committed to his own.
He really did. What a fine, fine year. Swisher takes a strike on the outside corner. One ball, one strike on Nick Swisher. 35 home runs for Swisher this year.
0 for 11 against Nate, so that's one good thing.
We like that.
I like that.
Power is good from both sides. The batting average is a little better from this side, the right side. Open stance, spreads out about midway in the right-handed batter's box. He got jammed in kind of a half cut. He bounces one past the A's dugout on the third base side, and again, we see Nate Robertson consistently ahead of the Oakland batters. A 1-2 count on Swisher, but so far they've gotten hits with a lot of two-strike and behind him the strike counts.
Well, that was a heck of a slider. That high angle from a left-hander down and into the right-hander, that was kind of like a self-defense swing. It was going to come in and maybe even hit him, but he got a piece of it.
Chavez on at first. Nate working from the third base side of the rubber. There's a fastball strike. He absolutely froze him for a called third strike. First strikeout for Nate.
That is following up the slider down and in. The fastball in the inner half of the plate. He's thinking it's another slider. And we've seen this many, many times from Nate Robertson. The slider affected down and in. The right-handers cannot pull the trigger when it's a fastball in the inner half of the plate.
We saw Swisher kind of nod his head and walk away. And I remember that same look, Jim, in his first at-bat against Verlander. And then
right.
He hit two home
That's
runs
right.
The next two at-bats.
That's right.
Now Marco Scudero. And listen to this crowd.
Well, they raved about, Ken Maka was raving about Scudero. He said defensively he's been flawless. And he brings a little spark, you know, to the ball club. But filling in for a heck of a shortstop, Crosby.
Marco Scudero, the chant here at the Coliseum. Next pitch, ground ball hit hard to second. Waist high bounce for Polanco to Guillen. One, the relay to first is in the dirt, scooped up by Casey. A 4-6-3 double play, and Marco Scudero ends the second for the Oakland A's. Tigers bat in the third. There's no score on the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. Nine American League pennants, four World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success, your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
What's your most productive time of day? Odds are, it's not after lunch. According to researchers, that's when 74% of us hit the wall. Now, you can get over that wall with 5-Hour Energy. Just one quick drink of 5-Hour Energy will help you feel alert and productive for hours. 5-Hour Energy is packed with B vitamins, enzymes, and amino acids. Zero sugar and just enough caffeine. So when you hit the wall, drink a 5-Hour Energy. It's available at Walgreens, 7-Eleven, GNC, Rite Aid, and Vitamin Shoppe.
Doma's Bell Tires Inventory Reduction Sale. Celebrate at all Detroit area locations. For the location nearest you, call 1-888-GO-BELL or check the new AT&T Yellow Pages. Hurry, sale ends soon. Bell Tires.
We give you the latest on every Tigers playoff game, 2-6, on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Bottom third of the order for the Tigers to face Barry Zito at the top of the third inning. Our third inning today brought to you by Lennox. The innovation never felt so good. Zito taking his final warm-up tosses right now. 28 years old, free agent. As this season comes to an end, this coming off season, and one of the big decisions that Billy Bean had, the general manager, was whether to trade him. And Jim, the speculation right from the start of the season to the trade deadline was that the A's might well trade Barry Zito because, well, he's going to be a free agent, and Billy Bean's track record was trading away guys before they became free agents. But he really felt, even though his team was really a little over 500 at the time, that his best chance of winning the division, and he thought there was a good chance, was with Barry Zito. And for one of the few times, he kept a potential big-name free agent here so that his team could get into the postseason.
Well, he's pretty right about that, but all I read now is that he's going to the Yankees.
Well,
they get everybody.
Of course he's going to the Yankees.
Just ask the media in New York.
Monroe, Thames, and Inge against Barry Zito here in the third, a scoreless game. The first pitch to Craig Monroe is in tight, ball one. Craig 3 for 16. with a couple of home runs and a big, big home run against the Yankees in Game 4 in Detroit. Next pitch is off the plate inside, and Zito will give up the home runs. As Jim mentioned, 27 home runs during the regular season. Tigers trying to push that pitch count for Barry Zito. Haven't made him work too hard yet. There's a swing and a miss. 2-1 on Craig Monroe. And Jim, very impressive behind almost every batter, and he keeps making quality pitches.
Yes.
Behind in the count.
And he's, all three of his pitches have been working, and he's added the slider also.
2-1 to Monroe, up and in with the fastball, and it's now 3-1. Craig getting the start in left field, and Marcus Thames again the DH. Sun has left the playing field. The outfield plays straight up. The 3-1 to Monroe is on the outside corner. Perhaps the biggest change for the A's in recent years is their emphasis on defense.
Yes.
It really started with the additions of Ellis and Kotze a few years ago at second and in center, and this year they made just 84 errors.
Number one.
Now Monroe fouls one out of play. A few years ago, they would just mash
yes,
the ball
yes.
and make 120 to 130 errors a
yes.
year, and they didn't really care.
But then they found out that, you know, pitching and defense will take you a long way, and hitting at the right time.
Now Zito comes right back. 3-2 pitch, swinging a fly ball deep to the right center field gap. Coming over the right fielder, Peter Bradley, and he'll make the catch on the run. That ball seemed to die as it headed up the gap.
Yeah, it did. It did. By the way, that Indian double play pulled off by the Tigers, that's a donation to Jack's Place for Autism from Zuber Buick. And don't forget the big event, November 11th. Brought to you by Jack's Place for Autism. Detroit teams up for autism, honoring the captain himself, Stevie Eiserman, November 11th. Check out jacksplaceforautism.com. Check them out on the web.
Time for Hoosier Tiger, brought to you by Murray's Discount Auto Stores, the auto parts supermarket. There's a strike to Marcus Thames. You take the guy in the on-deck circle, Brandon Inge. He didn't do a whole lot in the first round. I think he's ready to bust out here in the second. Here's a swing and a tap foul. His numbers against Barry Zito, notwithstanding.
Well, in that, then I'm going to stay with Nate, because even though Nate's given up some hits, he's kept them off the board.
0-2 on Marcus Thames. Scoreless game in the top of the third inning. We switch from a best-of-five series now to a best-of-seven. The first two here in Oakland, the next three in Detroit. Fastball rides up and in above the letters. 1-2 on Marcus Thames, and game 6 and 7 if need be. Would be back here in Oakland. Zito comes right back. The 1-2 pitch, broken bat, line drive foul into the stands, and the bat boy right on top of things delivers a new bat to Marcus.
It's early in the game, but we're seeing some things that I don't recall from Zito. Pitching inside more to right-handed batters, especially with the fastball. I don't remember that as much in his previous starts against us.
Now Thames waiting on a 1-2 pitch again. He swings and bounces one on a high chop to third. Backing up to play the bounce to Chavez. Throw to first, a strike to Swisher, and Thames is out number two. Barry Zito has now retired the first eight in order. Zito, 28 years old, not your typical lefty. He's not even left-handed, he says. He says, does everything that requires any dexterity with his right hand. And some would say he's a little flaky, but really he's not. He's the son of a musician and a pastor. Very thoughtful young man, well-read. He's got a little bit of a free spirit in him. No question about that. Brandon Inge takes a pitch off the plate inside.
California kid.
One heck of a left-handed pitcher. Very, very durable.
You're not kidding.
Now the 1-0 to Brandon, swing and a miss. Boy, he's got it going early on. There's no question about that.
Been interesting. He's had a pattern, and I'll try to the previous games. We haven't seen it yet here.
1-1 pitch, low and in.
Seemed like when he would throw a curveball, he'd like to follow up with an off-speed pitch. We haven't seen that in this game.
Again, a Tigers batter with a hitter's count. The 2-1 pitch, fly ball down the left field line. It is hooking, it is deep, and it is gone! Line drive home run right down the line off the bat of Brandon Inge. And the Tigers take a 1-0 lead here in the third. The first hard hit ball of the day is a home run.
3:30 down the line, we had to wait because it looked like it was curving foul just inside the fair pole. He got the pitch up in the zone, and he didn't miss it. And there's that good swing for Brandon Inge. We've been looking for that. But again, tried to come inside but left it out over the plate.
Five Finally, a Tigers batter takes advantage of a hitter's count. Now Curtis Granderson backed away by an inside pitch, and the Tigers get the early jump on Barry Zito and the Oakland A's. 1-0 here in the third. Now Curtis shows bunt, pulls the bat back. Ball went off the glove of Kendall, and it's the ball, and it's now 2-0. Very little difference, lefty-righty against Zito. They hit him the same for average and the same for power. Chavez, even with the base at third, rest of the infield back. Now the 2-0 pitch, line drive down the right field line. That's a fair ball into the corner. Granderson around first, headed to second. Bradley watches the ball die at the wall, and Curtis will hold with a two-out double. Home run and a double back-to-back after Zito had retired the first eight in order.
Maybe the hitting background got a little bit better. That was a terrific swing. That ball went down right below the 330 mark down the right field line. It was a fastball belt high, and it hit underneath at the bottom of the fence and didn't bounce off the fence, and the right fielder Bradley had to go get it and retrieve it, because I think maybe Curtis could have made it into third because the ball did not bounce off the wall at all.
Now the Tigers have the chance to add to a 1-0 lead. Polanco at the plate. He takes a pitch low. Tremendous success against Zito. And as we mentioned, a .500 batting average against the A's. 16 for 32 now, including one stretch where he had seven consecutive hits against the A's. In July, there's a pitch low and in. Let's pause briefly for station identification on the Detroit Tigers radio network.
The Sports Inferno, middays 10 to 2, only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station, WXYT Detroit, a CBS radio station.
Now the 2-0 to Placido, ooh, on the outside corner.
Boy, that was kind of stretched the strike, though. By the way, that home run's a Faygo home run, 99 years of Flavor Makers.
Granderson can take a pretty good-sized lead. Off of second base, the second baseman, Jimenez, is shaded toward the right side. There's a strike on the outside corner. Instead of being shaded up the middle, he actually shaded toward the hole. 2-2 now on Placido. Granderson at second. Tigers with the early 1-0 lead, thanks to the Brandon Inge home run. Zito sets, 2-2 pitch in the dirt. Blocked by Kendall moving to his left. Kendall does a nice job behind the plate, doesn't he?
He really does. You know, he's quick. He has soft hands. He works well with his pitchers. And he's a workhorse. I mean, to have a catcher that'll catch just about every game and then lead off for you. You don't see that very
often. No, you don't. Now Polanco digs back in. He's got a 3-2 count. Man on second and two outs. Tigers trying to add to a 1-0 lead here in the third. The payoff pitch. Low and outside. He walked him. How about this? The Tigers have put three consecutive batters on, a home run, double, and a walk after eight in a row had been retired by Barry Zito.
Very close pitch, but that's what we want to do, get some free passes off of this left-hander, get that pitch count up.
He'll walk about four batters per nine, and that's unusually high for a guy with this kind of success. Threw more pitches than any other pitcher in the American League this year, but that's par for the course. He does that every year.
He does.
For the last five for Barry Zito. Now Casey at the plate, and he takes a pitch low and outside, not missing by much. Casey hit the ball hard his first time up, but it was knocked down by Zito, and he was thrown out at first. Jimenez, the second baseman, a couple of steps onto the outfield grass. The shortstop, Scudero, shades up the middle just a little bit. There's a pretty big hole up the middle for Casey. There's a pitch low and outside. The appeal down to third, and Chuck Merriweather says he didn't go. 2-0 on Sean Casey.
Fans get a little restless here.
A's a very good home team this year, 49-32. The Tigers, the best road team in the American League, also 49-32. Now Casey waiting on a 2-0 pitch, swing and a foul fly down the left field line. That'll give about 10 rows back past the A's dugout.
Dan, we see the same defense against Sean Casey in the infield with the second baseman pull over towards first in the outfield, and we've seen him take that ball to the right of second base, especially against left-handers.
I mean, it never seems like the shortstop is in a position to
right.
Get that ball. The outfield plays him to go the opposite way. They're shallow.
especially the left fielder Peyton and the center fielder Katze. Left-handed batter against the lefty Zito. 2-1 pitch knocks him down. Oh, Casey went down in a heap. Rarely will you see a batter go down quite that fast and quite that in a heap in a batter's box, and he went down in a hurry.
He really did. His feet went right out from under him. It's the only way he could get out of the way of it. Fastball up and in.
That was almost head high, and when it's coming at your head, you really don't take any chance.
Don't like that. You don't like that.
Well, it'll make you a little less comfortable as you dig back in, won't it?
It sure does. But you got to bear down. You'll bear down a little bit more.
Now Zito sets the 3-1 to Casey. Ground ball hooked just foul down the first baseline. Tried to tuck it inside the bag, and now a full count will loosen the base runners at first and second. Peyton now actually backed up a few steps and left. Really, you've got three center fielders playing the outfield for the Oakland A's. Bradley, Peyton, and Katze have all played center field for long stretches in their careers. This crowd urging Zito to get the final out. He's given up a run here in the third, and the Tigers have an early 1-0 lead. He sets. 3-2 pitch. There go the runners. Swing and a foul back to the screen. Everybody will have to reset.
One of the things that Sean Casey normally does, it will shorten up plate protection, just trying to put it in play. And again, as hard as this infield is, take your chances with the ball in the ground.
Hit 296 of the Pirates. About 50 points lower than that with the Tigers, but a big first round against the Yankees, including quality at-bats against Randy Johnson. 6-17 in that series. Facing another tough lefty, Barry Zito. 3-2 pitch again. A little bit high. Oh, man, was that close. He walked him, and the bases are loaded.
Boy, and I'll bet you he's hearing it from that home dugout. A tough pitch to lay off of, but again, another good at-bat. Back-to-back walks here with a runner at the second base. Now we have the bases loaded with a double and two walks.
And suddenly, this crowd has grown a little bit silent here at the Coliseum.
Kurt Young, the pitching coach, out to chat with his veteran left-hander and veteran catcher. A lot of experience there with the catcher and the pitcher.
Well, this is a good early sign, I think, Jim, because the Tigers never really have worked many walks from Barry Zito.
And, you know, both pitches, the one Placido took and the one that Sean Casey took, very close.
A Brandon Inge home run with two outs started this uprising. Curtis Granderson followed with a double down the right field line. Now back-to-back walks to Polanco and Casey, and a big chance now for the Tigers to break through against the Barry Zito and add to a 1-0 lead. Magliordonez bounced out his first time up. The first pitch, swinging a ground ball, diving stop by Chavez, but he can't come up with it. Dove to his left, knocked it down, couldn't come up with it, and to score comes Granderson. It's an infield base hit. And the Tigers take a 2-0 lead.
He hit a rocket, but how about the reaction by the third baseman? I thought that ball was into left field, and we'd have possibly had two runs, but Chavez so quick and hit the heel of his glove and then bounced out, couldn't recover and make a play. But just getting to that rocket was one heck of a play.
Boy, had it. It looked like heel of his glove, top of his glove, and then it just wouldn't stay in. You expect a guy like him, that ball stays in his glove. Now Carlos Guillen at the plate. He swings and lifts a high foul right side and out of play. 2-0, Tigers with the lead. And all of this happening with two outs after Zito had retired the first eight batters he faced. Polanco the runner at third. Casey at second. Ordonez at first. Katze fairly shallow and shaded toward left center on Carlos Guillen. Swing and a miss. Breaking ball in under the hands, and Barry Zito now ahead. No balls, two strikes. Again, batting from the right side. He was tremendous from the right side in the second half after a slow start batting right-handed. Scudero at short will shade toward the hole just a little bit. Second baseman Jimenez shades up the middle. The kick in the 0-2 pitch. Off the plate inside. He's got Guillen lifting that back right foot out of the way. Two big walks to Polanco and Casey extended the inning. And then Ordonez got a run home with the infield base hit.
Zito way over on the third base side of the rubber, leans in to get the sign. He sets now, time called at home plate and granted to Carlos Guillen. Five straight batters have reached. Can Guillen make it six? Zito sets the pitch way out of the strike zone away, and boy, have they made him work hard and throw a lot of pitches here in the third.
Fastball down and in, now the fastball up and away, and you know, from a catcher's standpoint, this is the pitch you want to try to get the hitter, and Carlos knows that. Those last two pitches could be setting up the changeup or the breaking pitch.
Changeup's been good. See if Guillen gets it here. The 2-2 pitch, ground ball, tipped off the glove of Zito, but right to the second baseman Jimenez. It was the changeup. He gets the force on Ordonez at second, and the Tigers are out in the third, but they pick up a couple of runs. A's bat, bottom of the third, 2-0 Tigers. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
America's number one sports morning show joins Detroit's number one sports station. Mike and Mike in the Morning comes to 1270 XYZ, the sports station. Morning 6 to 10.
Somebody's going to have to come to the table awfully hard to jump into this crew.
Followed by the Sports Inferno with Mike Valenti and Jerry Foster. Middays 10 to 2. The Big Show with Doug Karsh and Art Regner. Afternoons 2 to 6. The Tiger Spotlight with Scott the Gator Anderson. Evenings at 6. Only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
This is the sound of a Cadillac DTS being scanned at over 100 points by a state-of-the-art laser system. The result? Every DTS must pass this final stringent test to ensure its fit and finish measures up to the best in the world. Drive DTS and discover other examples of this relentless search for excellence. Like a powerful Northstar V8 engine, or class-exclusive adaptive remote start, which starts the engine and engages personal driver preferences from nearly 200 feet away. Cadillac DTS. Life, liberty, and the pursuit. Class claim based on Auto Pacific 2006 large luxury car class.
Test drive a new Cadillac and find out more about our attractive lease or purchase offers. Visit your local Cadillac dealer.
Staples offers fast and easy business delivery at great low prices every day. Shop by phone or online 24/7. Call 1-800-STAPLES or shop staples.com. Staples, that was easy.
Tigers are taking Nate Robertson to a 2-0 lead. It's the bottom of the third inning. A's couldn't cash in on a scoring chance in the first with their big bopper at the plate, Frank Thomas. Tigers came through with two outs, scored two runs. Brandon Inns started things with a home run right down the line, and then Magler Ordonez with the infield base hit. And thanks to Chavez, it was only an infield base hit and one run instead of a hit that got to the outfield and scored two. Now Robertson to face D'Angelo Jimenez. And this is a replacement for Mark Ellis. And Jim, no one's trying to hide the fact that the loss of Mark Ellis in game two of the series against Minnesota is a huge loss. And Ken Maka and Ron Washington both said he's irreplaceable at second base.
They said his defense was so great. I mean, just steady, knows how to play the hitters.
There's a pitch outside. He made just two errors this year. Gold glove. He probably will win the gold glove at second base.
Very smart player and a hitter that will put the ball in play normally.
So Jimenez now is the starting second baseman. There's a strike at the belt. The one-time Yankee prospect who had the terrible car wreck right after he had a minor league season that put him on the charts for everybody in terms of a top prospect. Here's a pitch outside. He had the neck injury, and it's been a long road back, and he's really been kind of kicking around, but he was picked up off waivers earlier this year from the Texas Rangers.
It is amazing how certain things happen and certain picks and certain people go down. You got to plug the holes.
Now the 2-1 to the switch hitter. He swings and lifts a high fly ball down the right field line. Ordonez races over. He'll make the catch right on the line in fair territory, according to the right field umpire, Mike Riley. One up and one down here in the third. 2-0 Tigers in the bottom of the third inning. The first best of seven with the Oakland A's. Last time they met, 1972, it was a best of five. That's how long ago it was for the American League Championship Series.
Yeah, this is a much different series, seven games, and Jim Leland was talking about that. You can win the first game or lose the first game, and it's got a long way to go.
There's a strike at the knees on the outside corner to Kendall, and the 2-3-2 format also changes things up, puts a premium on those home games. If you've got games 3, 4, and 5 at home, there's a strike at the belt and also rewards, I think, a team that plays well on the road like the Tigers did all season. Because you're going to have to face, perhaps, a game 6 or 7 on the road to clinch a series. Now, Kendall waiting on the 0-2 pitch. Up and in. He didn't miss by much with the fastball. Tough to strike this guy out. He generally will put the ball in play. And that's the other thing that jumps out at you with the A's. Not only do they walk a lot, they don't strike out a whole lot either. Kendall bends at the waist, out over the plate, chokes up. He takes a pitch high and outside. He singled his first time up. A sharp line drive single to left past Carlos Guillen. Granderson in center, shallow and shaded way over toward right center. Same for Ordonez in right. He is shallow and straight up. 2-2 from Nate. Swing and a foul over the screen just to our right. 2-0 Tigers in the bottom of the third inning.
It'll be good to see that they could have a quick inning here. Tough first inning. Gave up a single in the second inning. Double play got him out of trouble, but we need a 1-2-3 inning here.
Nate shakes off Pudge. Now he's got a sign he likes. 2-2 pitch to Kendall. Just off the plate outside. And he's now worked the count full. Marcotte waiting on deck. Pretty breezy day, but we never can really tell what the wind is doing
crazy
inside
here,
the stadium.
It is crazy.
Comes in and swirls. 3-2 pitch. Swing and a tap foul. He had a big rip and tapped it just foul behind home plate.
There are two openings down the right field line and left field line. You watch one flag that seems to be blowing one way. The other flags are blowing the other way. So you really can't tell what's happening.
Now the payoff pitch. A little bit high with a fastball. Kendall drops the bat, heads down to first with a one-out walk here in the third. Base runners in every inning for the Oakland A's.
First time, I think they tried to overthrow. He flares open that lead shoulder, the ball up and away.
You remember, Jim, before they built the Mount Davis in center field or stands?
It was beautiful. You could see the mountains back there. It was a major difference. It really was. And Mount Davis, well, it's good for football, but bad for baseball. But
just picture a straight line, basically, of football stands running down one full sideline of an NFL field, and that's to have. Here's a ground ball up the middle. Glove knocked down by Guillen, but like Chavez, he can't get a handle on it. He threw it away, but Nate Robertson will just pick it up. He made a fine diving stop. Couldn't field it cleanly. It's a base hit for Kotze, and once again, the A's have two men on.
Yeah, another good swing. That ball up in the zone off the slant of Nate Robertson. What a play, really, by Guillen just to get over there. The ball skidded a little bit. All they could do is knock it down. Couldn't recover in time to get the force to second base. But another good swing after a walk.
And really, Jim, that's different from other games where they would just have one or two innings where there would be good swings.
Exactly.
But not throughout the game. And you're right, every inning, good swings against Nate. Now Milton Bradley steps to the plate. One of three switch batters in Ken Maka's lineup tonight. Deep in the right-handed batter's box with an open stance. The first pitch is the slider in under the hands and a peel down to first. Hunter Wendelstadt says he didn't go. Bradley sharply singled to left his first time up. Most of his at-bats came from the left side. Only 90 at-bats from the right side. He had a little better average, a little more power from the right side. The 1-0 pitch here. Ground ball up the middle. Guillen has it. Backhand flip to Polanco. Relay to first. Double play. Neatly turned by Guillen and Polanco. And once again, Nate Robertson comes up with a big pitch with men on. After three in Oakland, it's the Tigers 2 and the A's nothing. On the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
Ground ball to second base. This will do it. Polanco to Casey. Tigers have eliminated the Yankees. Yankees.
Thanks for the love, Detroit fans. And thanks for helping the Tigers advance to the 2006 American League Championship Series. The roar rages on at Tigers.com, the official Major League online home for Detroit Tigers baseball. Go to Tigers.com to get tickets, get authentic playoff gear, listen live and watch on demand. And yeah, bring on the Athletics. Tiger up at Tigers.com.
We're overstocked with car tires, truck tires, SUV tires, tires for imports, tires for domestics, trailer tires, and more. So we're having an inventory reduction sale with huge markdowns for you, only at Bell Tire. That's right. We'd rather drastically discount our name brand inventory than count it. That means big savings. For a limited time only at Bell Tire, you'll find huge discounts on the biggest selection of in-stock tires and get 12 months zero interest. Save on the top name brands like Goodyear, Kelly, Michelin, Toyo, Continental, and more. But with our guaranteed lowest out-the-door pricing, you never pay for extras. Nitrogen insulation, valve stems, mounting, balancing, and tire disposal are free. And right now at Bell Tire, with approved credit, you can get 12 months zero interest when you make a purchase of $500 or more on your Goodyear credit card. See store for details. Don't need tires? Bell Tire's ASC certified technicians can perform a full menu of automotive services. Hey, this may be your last chance this year to take advantage of prices this low. Don't miss the inventory reduction sale only at Bell Tire.
Don't miss Bell Tire's inventory reduction sale. Celebrate all Detroit area locations. For the location near you, call 1-888-GO-BELL or check the new AT&T Yellow Pages. Hurry, sale ends soon. Bell Tire. Size does matter. Red Wing Shoes has locations in Lansing, Holt, Grand Rapids, Saginaw, and 9 Metro Detroit stores. Go to a Red Wing Shoe store near you. Red Wing Shoes. Built to fit. Built to last.
Golic here. We talk Tigers in the ALCS morning, 6 to 10 on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Good news from Oakland, California. Tigers 2, the A's nothing. Brandon Ninja's home run with two out in the third. And double by Granderson, back-to-back walks to Polanco and Casey. Infield base hit by Ordonez, and we lead 2-0. And a couple good double plays induced off the slants of Nate Robertson, even though Danny is living dangerously. That last one off the bat of Bradley was hit very hard up the middle. He had made a good play, and they turned two.
He did, and you just you got to turn that around, or those good swings are going to catch up to him. But his history is that he will limit these A's and limit the good swings.
It'll be Rodriguez, Monroe, and Timms to face the left-hander, Barry Zito. Told you he's walked a couple. He's not struck out a batter yet, giving up three hits all in the third.
And we talked about pushing that pitch count, Jim. 69 pitches
going
in
into the
three
fourth.
Innings.
Very good. Rodriguez grounded out his first time up. This inning brought to you by Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Fastball high and outside. Chavez in on the grass quickly at third base, suspicious of Pudge. Now the left-hander's next offering. Chopper foul, third base side. He's mixed his changeup in very nicely so far. He's going up to 91 with the fastball. The changeup has been pretty good, and the curveball at times has been exceptional. Big curveball, what a beauty. Oh, my goodness, he called it a ball.
Oh.
Ball two, strike one. That floors just about everybody.
That was a thing of beauty.
Hitters count once again for the Tigers. Change up, fly ball, deep center field. Going back is Kotze, and he will watch it go out of here. Pudge Rodriguez touch them all over the 388 mark in right center field. Holy mackerel, what a good swing by Rodriguez. Tigers lead 3-0, two home runs in the ballgame.
Jim, I think he was sitting on a changeup in a 2-1 count, and he absolutely was all over it to drill it out. That is not an easy part of the ballpark to hit it out over that high wall.
Yeah, high wall, 388. Kotze ran out of room. What a good swing by Pudge. This is Monroe, up and in, ball one. Another Faygo home run. Craig flied out the right his first time up. Upstairs, 2-0. We're going to foul back off the fastball this time. Two Tiger home runs, Inge and now Rodriguez, and RBI single by Ordonez. Tigers lead 3-0. Four hits for each ball club.
High and outside, 3-1. Tigers laying off that high fastball here in this ballgame. Change up right down the heart of the plate, 3-2.
Well, think how big that curveball called for a ball.
Oh,
and bit of a strike was on Pudge.
Low, ball four, another walk issued by the left-hander. That's three in this ball game, and Jason Kendall will go out and have a little chat with him. By the way, that other inning-ending double play pulled off by the Tigers, another donation for Jack's Place for Autism, donated by Zuber Buick.
Number 33, Marcus Tim.
Kurt Young, pitching coach, out again. Saw him in the last inning. We told you he walked 75 during the regular season, or 99, I'm sorry, in 221 innings. He struck out 151. Pretty good action in the pen for the A's early in the ballgame.
The Tigers have never knocked him out before the sixth inning.
Conversation over with. Tigers on top, 3-0.
Chad Godin is up and getting ready to throw.
Marcus Timms will step in the batter's box. Marcus 0 for 1, a ground out. Ground ball, backhanded by Chavez. He's got the second, gets the fourth, over to first. Wild throw. Marcus Timms will head to second base. Switch to the first baseman, gets it quickly, but Timms into second, unable to complete the double play. And, boy, you have to say Craig Monroe got on Jimenez at second awfully quick.
He did, and that's one of the things they're worried about Jimenez, about turning that double play. Ellis probably turns that because he really, Jim, had plenty of time. And for the time he had, that was an awful throw to first base after a very neat pickup by Chavez at third.
Should have been two, there's no doubt about that, and just a horrible throw by Jimenez at second base. And we were told that this could be a problem. It has showed up in this game already.
I mean, I'm not sure how you make a throw that bad. Bounced hard in the dirt 10 feet from home or from first base.
Now Brandon steps in, hit his first postseason home run, his first time up. Line drive down the left field line. Inside with the first offering for a ball. Remember, he had 27 home runs during the regular season. Low once again, 2-0 on Brandon, runner at second, one down. Tigers lead 3-0.
Doesn't let come in fastball here, and we saw Pudge sit on a changeup ahead in the count.
Long drive up the gap in left center field. Kotze going over. It is off the wall. That will score Marcus Timms from second into second base. Is Brandon is with an RBI double, and the swings started in the third. They've continued here in the fourth. Tigers lead 4-0.
And again, he sat on a changeup, 2-0, and just missed hitting his second home run.
Boy, the mistake by Jimenez, the second baseman, opened up the gates. 4-5-0 for the Tigers, 0-4-1 for the A's. Brandon with back-to-back good swings off of Zito. Now Granderson, he doubled in the third, eventually scored on the infield single by Ordonez. Inside corner called strike. Boy, this crowd has quieted down somewhat. Chopper right side. Swisher will get it. Step on the bag. Two down. Brandon over to third. Blessed will bring up Placido Polanco. 7 for 12 off of Zito. Grounded out his first time. He walked the next time.
Number 14, Placido Polanco.
7 for 17 in the series against the Yankees. Outside with the first offering. Inge at third, two down. Outfield shallow, shaded a little bit towards right. We're going to foul out of play. Late on the fastball inside. Zito ready. Outside with the two-seamer. Two and one. Another hitter's count. Boy, this has been something for our hitters in this ballgame against Zito.
Almost every batter in this game.
Blanco waiting on the 2-1. Outside. 3-1 with Sean Casey on deck.
Tough to walk Placido twice in a game, but he also knows the history against it.
That's right. Yeah, we'll see what happens on the 3-1. Line drive back through the middle. Solid base hit. Brandon Inge comes in to score. 5-0 Detroit. Boy, was that a bullet.
Eight for 13 in his career against Barry Zito with that hit.
Boy, and you think the double play that should have been made. We have been so good during the year taking advantage of mistakes and teams that had the inability to complete plays. We're seeing it here tonight.
Well, they knew where they were going to miss Ellis. They didn't think it'd show up quite this quickly. Boy. Second game that he's been gone.
This is Casey, 0-for-1 with a walk. Swing and a pop-up, third base side. Chavez has room. He tries to hunt it down. He cannot make the play. Boy, oh boy, a long way. Went sliding and just could not get it. A home run by Rodriguez. A walk to Monroe, which should have been a double play off the bat of Timms. And Jimenez, the second sacker, threw the relay away. He ended up at second base. Brandon with a double, and then Polanco with a single. Line drive, right center field. That will fall in for another base hit. Placido around second, and he'll head over to third. Little Texas Ligger off the bat of Sean Casey. Runners on the corners with two down. And I think the skipper's going to come out, Ken Maka.
Yep.
How about that? You get rid of their number one pitcher here in the fourth inning with a little bit of everything. Started with the home run. 5-0, 7 hits for the Tigers, 4 hits, no runs for the A's. We're going to take a break. We'll come right back and tell you about the new A's pitcher after this timeout.
So, accident fund's going to make this place safer, huh? Well, what could be safer than a dairy farm? I ask you. Things are pretty tame here at National Tiger Milk. There's not much to it, really. We feed the tigers, we milk the tigers. And that's about it. Why, the only remotely dangerous aspect of National Tiger Milk is hooking up the milking machine.
Oh, wait. It's bad. Get it.
And we got a guy who's real good at that. Right, Lefty?
Gosh, oh my.
Sometimes it's hard, sometimes it's easy. But at the Accident Fund, we can always find ways to keep your workers safer and your insurance premiums lower. Ask your agent about Accident Fund Workers' Compensation Insurance or log on to accidentfund.com for an agent near you.
This here is Lefty. He's my right-hand man.
Hi.
Accident Fund Insurance Company of America. Safer together.
Detroit Tigers Baseball is brought to you by Accident Fund Insurance Company of America. For more information about Accident Fund, your WorkSafe partner for workers' compensation, call your independent insurance agent.
Hear the hometown call of every Tiger playoff game only on 1270XYT, the sports station.
Barry Zito had a lifetime ERA against the Tigers of 268 and a 7-5 career record. He is gone. This is something the way this Tiger team is swinging the bats. And Dan, I think the walks were a key part of it. So he is gone, and Chad Godin is the new pitcher. He's a right-hander.
This right-hander defied a little bit of the odds this year, Jim. 55 appearances, 64 innings of work, a 3.09 ERA. 51 hits in those innings, so that all looks very good. But Jimmy walked 42 in those 64 innings and struck out 36. It is rare to do that and have an ERA like that. 42 walks in 64 innings with 51 hits and only 36 strikeouts. He did get a little bit lucky, but again, he's very tough when he's not wild.
Probably shows they have some good defense behind him.
I think so.
He'll be facing Maglio Ordonez. 1-for-2, RBI single. Swing and a pop-up, foul territory, right side. Swisher giving chase, the first baseman. He'll run out of room. It is in the stands. My goodness, did he have a long run. And they even have some extra seats down both lines now because of this, the playoffs, and still a long run.
Jim, how about this? Five games in a row where the Tigers have faced a pitcher that had success against them either in their career or this year. Four Yankee starters and Zito tonight. And in each game, we've seen good swings. And a couple of times, starter knocked out early.
It is a terrific sign. Maglio now waiting on the next offering from the right-hander. Slider outside. Even the count at 1-1. Polanco at third. Casey at first. Three runs are in, two in the third, three here in the fourth. Then we have a chance to get more. Outside corner called, strike two, 1-2 to Maglio. Ball look in by the right-hander, goes to the set. Way outside, it's a 2-2 count with Carlos Guillen on deck. Three and two-thirds for Barry Zito and seven hits.
Had never gone less than six in 14 starts against the Tigers.
A 2-2 from the right-hander. Foul out of play, fouled off a good pitch to stay alive. And this crowd that was, it was bonkers leading up to the game, and all of a sudden, boy.
Got a little Tiger section right down to our right that's making a lot of noise.
Ground ball right side, right to Hernandez. He's up with it over to first. They get Mags, but not before. They pick up three. It is 5-0 Detroit. The home of Tiger Ball. We will be right back.
All right. If you work on your car, one thing you should know. A man named Murray is going to save you some dough.
Okay, so you work on your car and you know that Murray's Discount Auto Stores have great ASE certified people and guaranteed low prices on a huge selection of name brand auto parts and accessories. But did you also know Murray's offers great free services like free oil recycling, free wiper blade installation, and free electrical testing? All true. So now that you know, remember this.
A man named Murray's gonna save you some dough.
Looking for a new truck? Here's the case for the 2007 Chevy Silverado Classic. Now it's backed by the GM 100,000-mile, 5-year powertrain limited warranty. Whichever comes first, better than Ford, better than Dodge. Case closed. See dealer for details. Eligible GM employee program participant. Get an 07 Silverado Classic half-ton crew cab LT 4x4. Starting at $28,813. MSRP. Tax title license dealer fees and optional equipment extra. See dealer for details. Or visit us online at ChevyDrivesTheMotorCity.com to view current offers, our lineup, or locate a dealer near you. Chevy Silverado. With the GM 100,000-mile, 5-year powertrain limited warranty. That's an American Revolution. Chevy drives the Motor City. See your Detroit area Chevy dealer today.
Hey, this is Art Rudner. We give you the latest on every Tigers playoff game afternoon from 2 to 6 on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
What an offensive show for the Tigers so far. What a job they have done. They knocked out Barry Zito with 3 2/3, 7 hits, given up 5 runs and 2 home runs. Dave Robertson's lived dangerously, but a couple double plays in the second and third have helped get him out of any trouble. He'll be facing Thomas,
Peyton and Chavez here in the bottom of the fourth inning. I'd like to remind everybody, you can sign up today for the 2007 Tigers full season tickets and guarantee your ability to purchase tickets to all potential World Series home games. Call 313-471-BALL or visit Tigers.com. Find out more about this offer. The DH lead off, Frank Thomas, who had some kind of year for this ball club. 39 home runs. He drove in 114. Has had a couple home runs in postseason play in Minnesota. Lined out his first time up sharply to Granderson in center field. First pitch outside for a ball. 5-7-0 for Detroit. 0-4-1 for the A's. A very costly error by their second sacker. Inside, 2-0. Tate needs to try to stay within himself now, not try to overthrow.
Tigers have done a very good job against Frank Thomas the last couple of years, and they've done it a lot by pounding him inside.
Outside corner. Boy, the plate has gotten wide, and we like that. Called strike 2-1 to Frank Thomas. Jay Peyton waits on deck. High and outside, 3-1 to the leadoff batter here in the fourth. Robertson's walked the batter. He has struck out one.
Make him put it in play right here.
Inside and low, ball four. Second walk issued by Nate Robertson. Tigers on top, 5-0.
Tigers did a very good job against the other patient team, the New York Yankees, is right behind the Oakland A's in walks. In those four games, just 8 walks in the four games, and none, or only a couple, after Justin Verlander's 4 walks in his starting game two.
Peyton takes the first pitch outside, and that means Rodriguez will head right to the mound. After a walk and a first pitch to the next batter, that's what happens here with the Tiger team. Wanted to cut it off right here, out, pats him on the back, now back behind the plate.
Well, he's got that hard ground ball working up the middle with men on base.
Yes,
see if
sir.
He can do it again.
Double plays already. Let's have another one. And remember, the A's led the American League in hitting in the double plays. Inside and low, 2-0. Called strike. Well, you hear the fans. Rodriguez had to reach up to make the catch.
Again, a very aggressive swinger at the plate. Very tough guy to walk. He generally will put the ball in play.
Nate leans in to get the sign. It's 2-1. Popped up right side. That'll reach the seats foul. Sean Casey gets chase just in case, but about 10 rows in. But he was the count at 2-2. 5-0 Detroit. 2 in the third, 3 in the fourth. After Zito had set down 8 in a row pretty easily.
And then in the last 14 he faced, 10 batters reached.
Unreal.
It didn't make a whole lot of sense.
Complete turnaround. Thomas on at first. Swing and a foul out of play. Ball 2 and strike 2. Peyton had 10 home runs during the regular season with a .296 average. Robertson's 2-2. Well, fly ball left field. Going back is Monroe. He's up on the wall. It bounces away from him. Thomas grounds second, and he will get to third. He'll have to be held there.
It's a double off the bat of Payton off the wall. Look for a second, maybe like Craig would get back there and get it, but he couldn't get back and make the play. Runners at second and third, and nobody down for Chavez.
Well, I guess the good news is he kept it in the ballpark because Payton has just killed him the last 2 years here, and this time it was a double instead of a home run, and because Frank Thompson simply can't run well, he's at third instead of it being a 5-1 game.
Here comes the Dean himself, Jim Leland. And we're going to get action in the pen already. Jamie Walker starts to toe the slab in the bullpen.
Yep, there's no way Jim Leland's going to mess around with this lead.
And Jason Brilli will join him. Tigers lead 5-0. We're in the fourth inning. This A's ball club only hit 260 during the season average-wise, but they were just had a way to make things happen.
This is a big batter right here for Nate if he wants to stay in this game. Chavez did not hit lefties this year. Nate did a superb job shutting down lefties. He'll gladly give up a run for an out right here.
Infield will be back. Chavez with a sharp single his first time up. Swing and a foul. As we mentioned earlier, with a lot of different injuries, I guess the forearm injury is the toughest that he, as far as swinging the bat, especially for power. 22 home runs. Ground ball, left side, fielded by the third base coach, that's Ron Washington. But Nate out in front, 0-2. Nate has had a knack of digging deep with runners in scoring position. We saw so many times during the regular season.
Tremendous ability. One out, none out. He ended up stranding so many runners at third.
See what he does on the 0-2 to Chavez. Way outside, ball one. Nick Swisher, the on-deck batter. Chavez drove in 72 during the regular season. Inside, moves him off the plate to make it a 2-2 count. Thomas at third, Payton at second. One home run this postseason. And a miss. Good breaking ball. Had him out in front in a perfect spot. Big strikeout for Nate Robertson. His second in the ballgame. One of the other power guys on this ball club, Nick Swisher, struck out his first time up. Cruz with a fastball in the inner half of the plate. 35 home runs during the regular season, 95 runs driven in. The field stays back. Outside and high, ball one.
Struck out a lot this year, but mostly from the left side, and a much higher strikeout rate as a left-handed batter.
Way outside, backhanded by Rodriguez. Ball two and no strikes. Marco Scudero, the on-deck batter. Walker and Grilly loosening up in our pen. That's down the right field line. See what he gets on the 2-0. Popped him up right below us here. Had him out in front, an off-speed pitch. So it's 2-1. The Tigers have 5 runs on 7 hits. The A's have not scored. They have 5 hits, 1 costly error. He leans in to get the sign from Rodriguez. Gets one he likes, goes to the set.
Check, swing, foul, just like the first time up. Almost looked like it was an afterthought. And right after that, the first time up, we got him with the fastball in the inner half of the plate.
Absolutely
throws
him, yeah.
Pusher out of the box, now back in, waiting on the 2-2. Chopper foul, third base side.
Came back with the same pitch, thinking that Swisher might be looking for that fastball. Slider down and in, just got a piece of it.
Thomas at third, Peyton the runner at second, one down, 5-0 Tigers. The 2-2, swing and a miss, he struck him out. Back-to-back strikeouts after a walk and a double, he strikes out Chavez, and now Nick Swisher.
Sometimes you get away with a pitch that's not what you intended. Pudge setting up low and inside. It was a fastball that was high and outside.
Would have been ball three. Scudero, the batter, grounded into a double play his first time up. Outside corner called strike. That plate is very wide for Jerry Crawford, the home plate umpire. Now Scudero asks for timeout. He gets it out of the box. Inside, 1-1.
And it seems like that pitch, Jim, above the belt has been at times a strike and at other times a ball.
Been inconsistent with the calls behind the plate. Scudero has 6 runs driven in this postseason. So he's dangerous. Foul out of play, right side. 8 to head in the count, 1-2.
Another 5 home runs this year. 3 came against the Tigers.
Rodriguez out to chat with him. I always like this, be on the same page. Now Robertson gets the sign. Just misses, a little bit high apparently. Ball 2 and strike 2. Jimenez waits on deck.
Boy.
Ball 2, strike 2, 2 on, 2 down. High, ball 3. Robertson has walked 2. He has struck out 3. Well, we talk about big pitches. Here's one right here for the Tigers. Thomas at third, Peyton at second, 2 down, 5-0 Detroit. Now Scudero asks for time again. The 3-2 offering is not going to be thrown because Scudero asked for time once again. Now he's ready, the 3-2.
Called strike 3. He struck out the side after a walk and a double. He struck out Chavez, Swisher, and Scudero. What a job by Nate Robertson. We have played 4. It's 5-0 Detroit. This is the 1270 XYT Tigers Baseball Network.
What size work boots do you wear? Do a number and a letter come to mind, like 10D, for instance, or just a number? Red Wing shoes come in hundreds of different sizes and widths, because that's where feet come in. And for our customers, that means more comfortable feet and a more comfortable shift. Hey, size and width do matter. Red Wing shoes, built to fit, built to last, since 1905.
Size does matter. Red Wing shoes, with locations in Lansing, Holt, Grand Rapids, Saginaw, and 9 Metro Detroit stores.
And now, another Comcast Consumer Update.
I'm here with the fastest pitcher in the league, Detroit's own Joel Zamaya, known for his blazing 103-mile-an-hour fastball.
Thanks, but that's still not as fast as Comcast high-speed internet.
Well, Comcast high-speed internet is true high-speed, and now with Power Boost, it's even faster.
What?
You can download photos, files, music, and more faster than ever.
Mm-hmm.
Power Boost is an extra surge of power that kicks in for downloading up to twice as fast.
That's like pitching 206 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Is the competition that fast?
Well, let's just say they only throw slow curveballs.
Well, where do I sign with Comcast?
Just call 1-888-COMCAST to get Comcast high-speed internet for $19.99 a month for 4 months.
This has been a Comcast Consumer Update.
New customers only. After promotion, standard rate supply, installation, taxes, and franchise fees extra. Actual speeds may vary. Power Boost speed claims and references are for downloads only and are available with 6 meg and 8 meg speed plans. Limited time offer. Other restrictions apply.
Detroit Tigers playoff baseball is brought to you by Michigan's most trusted name in healthcare, Blue Cross Blue Shield, a nonprofit corporation and independent licensee of the Blue Cross Blue Shield Association.
The Tigers are in the playoffs, and we're covering them middays, 10 to 2 on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
What a job by Nate Robertson. A leadoff walk to Frank Thomas, a double by Pate, runners a second and third. He strikes out Chavez and Swisher, both swinging. Then Scudero takes a pitch. Dan, looked like to me had a lot of the plate.
Looked like it was right down the middle.
It really did. What a job, and perhaps that'll take a little more heart out of this Oakland A's team.
Oh, that's just huge. You've got the crowd back into the game after they were silenced by the 5-0 Tigers lead. Payton had just missed a home run, and Scudero delivered big hits in that series against the Minnesota Twins with, as you mentioned, 6 RBIs. I think that's just very, very big for Nate and the Tigers.
Tigers with 2 in the 3rd, 3 in the 4th, 5-0 Detroit. This inning brought to you by the Michigan Regional Council of Carpenters. Log on to Hammer9.com.
I think a little extra motivation when he saw the activity in the bullpen.
Oh, baby. Bulldog put in another gear, didn't he?
He did. Fun to watch.
This is Guillen. He's 0 for 2, but the Tigers have picked up 5 on 7 hits, all off of the starter, Barry Zito. This is Godin, the right-hander. There's a strike to him.
Tigers did very little against Godin during the season. 2 different appearances, 5 total innings, and he did not score in those 5 innings.
Just a sharp fastball and a short slider. Ground ball hit very hard to Scudero. It's short, right at him, over to first. One down. Reminder, 2006 playoff sweep packages for American League Championship games, potential World Series games are on sale right now. Multi-game and individual game packages are available. But each package includes sweep nights for the 2007 season. Check it out, 313-471-2222, before these playoff sweep packages are all sold out. Rodriguez, the batter, a ground out, and then a home run right center field off of Barry Zito to lead off the 4th. Swing and a miss. Rodan, low 90s with the fastball. Fly ball, right field. Milton Bradley drifts over towards the line, and he'll take it for out number 2. Pause to let our stations along our Tiger Network identify themselves.
Mike and Mike in the morning. Morning 6 to 10. Only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station. WXYZ Detroit, our CBS radio station.
Monroe, the batter with 2 down, a fly out and a walk. Greg has 2 home runs in this postseason action, February of 27 during the season. Yeah.
inside for a ball from the right-hander. Rodan's a long-arm thrower. You can see him really reach back and kind of slings the ball. Pitches from the set. There's a strike to him. Even the count at 1-1 with two down. Tigers lead 5-0. Ground ball right to Chavez at third. Up with it. He'll gun over to first. Tigers go down 1-2-3. But Tigers are on top 5-0. Throwing the Tiger ball. We'll be right back.
Pop's here to give whatever advice you seek. All right, I got John from West Bloomfield. You're on the air.
I have a question about investments.
You do know my expertise is soda pop, but okay, what the heck?
What's the best way to maximize my dollar in today's market?
Ah, Faygo.
Faygo?
Yep, Faygo is the best value in any market.
Any market?
Definitely. Your supermarket, your potty store, convenience store.
So what you're saying is it's a buyer's market.
And our little secret.
Faygo. Always a good buy.
It begins with a slow dance of turning leaves and crescendos in a trillion trees of flame. For the next several weeks, the curtain rises on the greatest show on earth as the 19 million acres of woods called Michigan slowly explode in a frenzy of color. The show plays along every stretch of highway and coastline in every city and town. Admission is free, and great seats are available everywhere. We can go to the movies this weekend, we can stay home and watch TV, or we can get up, get out, and go see something we'll remember for the rest of our lives. An entire state in its annual blaze of glory. This show is appropriate for all ages. This show is pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Hey fans, sign up today for the 2007 Detroit Tigers full season tickets and guarantee your ability to purchase tickets to all potential World Series home games at Comerica Park. Call 313-471-BALL or visit Tigers.com for details.
Game one here in Oakland, American League Championship Series. The Tigers are on a roll after taking three in a row against New York, and they've come out here tonight with fire in their eyes, and well, they're playing the same way. They're swinging the bats. Nate Robertson has struggled. He's given up five hits, but boy, oh boy, the fourth inning with a leadoff walk to Thomas, a double by Payton, the strikeout Chavez, Swisher, and Scudero. Doesn't get much better than that.
Really doesn't. That activity in the bullpen, Jim Leland was not going to mess around with a 5-0 lead, and Nate answered. He answered big time, and man, we've seen him do it all year, but doesn't get much bigger stage in the American League Championship Series until the World Series, and that's just very, very clutch pitching.
Jimenez, Kendo, and Katse will face Nate here in the bottom of the fifth. There's a strike to him. He flied out weakly to right field his first time out. Remember, Mark Ellis, the regular second baseman, out with a broken finger. Just misses outside, makes it a 1-1 count. Nate had 32 starts during the regular season and pitched into the seventh in 22 of them. That's consistency. Line drive, left field, base hit. They gave him an off-speed pitch, and he didn't miss it. Drilled it into the left, leadoff single.
I guess Nate just feels more comfortable being on base tonight.
Yeah, we need another ground ball double play right here.
That's all.
Jason Kendall, the leadoff batter, he singled and walked. They gave up two hits in the first. They stranded two. He gave up a leadoff single in the second, but a strikeout and a double play. And then in the third, a single and a walk, but he got a double play. Outside for ball one. .295 average during the regular season. inside, 2-0, and I would think that pen will be on high alert. Walker and Grilly were up in the last inning. Outside corner, called strike. 2-1. Crawford on that pitch away from right-handers has extended the home plate. And they've taken advantage of that. Now timeout called at home plate. They've done that a lot to Nate tonight. Kendall hits him an open stance on the right side. Chopper foul, third base side. Good off-speed pitch. Even the count at 2-2. Jason Kendall hit one home run during the regular season. Robertson ready with the 2-2. Foul out of play, right side. Once the sun goes down out here, it gets a little cooler, but it's very pleasant here tonight. Of course, we're tucked in up here. We're not down there with the...
We're nice and sheltered,
yeah,
aren't
with
we?
The folks, so... Infield double play depth. Gap in left center field for Kendall as he gets the 2-2. Up and in, full count. And as the runner at first, he singles. Hase on deck. Payoff pitch, outside, ball four. Nate unhappy with himself, and he should be. That'll get that pen busy again. Single and a walk. Looks like it might be the same two,
yeah.
Walker and Grilly.
Looks like it.
Chuck Fernandez coming out, the old pitching coach. Dan, I think he's done a great job with these pitchers this year. Working with pitching coaches during my career, his demeanor is so good. And he knows that each one has a different personality. He knows their hot and cold buttons.
And each time a pitcher had that little rough streak, he knows how to get him out of it. He keeps it very simple. I think he gave Jeremy Bonderman a lot of confidence and a very simple game plan going into that start against the Yankees.
Simplicity. Too much... information is not good. Not enough is not good. So he's got to need that happy medium, and that's what he's good at. Marcotte will step in. Left-handed hitting center fielder. 1-for-2. He singled his last time up. 2 on, nobody down. 5-0 Detroit. Field double play depth. Low ball one. Side ball two. Very close to offering from Robertson, but he's behind 2-0 to Tate. Milton Bradley, the on-deck batter. Going on a chopper foul at home plate. Robertson has walked three. He has struck out four. Robertson 2-1. Chopper to second base, Maflocco. Over to Guillen. Over to first. Another Tiger double play. Boy, oh boy, three of them in this ball game, and we told you coming in, 170 double plays hit into by the A's. That led the American League, and we're seeing why here tonight.
Right fielder. Number
more base runners, more double plays, but man, oh man. The pitches he's been able to come up with, and Jim...
each time he was behind in the count when he got the ground ball for the double play.
Living dangerously, but doing the job. That's three double plays for the Tigers tonight. This is Bradley with a runner at third and two down. A little fly ball left field going over Monroe. Does he make the catch? He makes a tremendous catch. He takes an RBI single away from the Oakland A's. What a play by Craig Monroe. Milton Bradley, he can't believe it. Terrific defensive play by Craig Monroe. Fiver in the books. Tigers 5, the A's nothing. You're listening to 1270XYT, Detroit Tigers Baseball Network.
The Michigan Regional Council of Carpenters and Millwrights and Union Contractors build the landmarks where we work, learn, live, and play. The MRCC and the Union Contractors work across Michigan to refurbish schools, construct the business centers of tomorrow, and are important in the revitalization of Detroit's hospitality industry. Contractors depend on Union Carpenters and Millwrights for their skill and dedication. In return, employers can count on a job completed on time and on budget. A shared commitment to quality and safety on every job site has resulted in better cities, better schools, and stronger neighborhoods. MRCC members and union contractors create landmarks of tomorrow, today.
When you see the blue Old English D, you always think of the Detroit Tigers. And when you see the familiar Blue Cross and Shield, you always think of quality health care. Two great symbols, two great institutions, one great state. The Tigers have been here since 1901, winning games, winning pennants, and winning our hearts. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan has been here since 1939, ensuring that every man, woman, and child in the state of Michigan has access to affordable, quality health care. And like the Tigers, they're here to stay. The Tigers have given the people of Michigan a lot of memorable moments. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan wishes the Tigers all the best in their drive to the championship. Because they believe in the Tigers. Because they believe in Michigan. Because Michigan is their home. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan is a nonprofit corporation and independent licensee of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association.
Size does matter. Red Wing Shoes has locations in Lansing, Holt, Grand Rapids, Saginaw, and 9 Metro Detroit stores. Go to a Red Wing Shoe store near you. Red Wing Shoes, built to fit, built to last.
We're talking Tigers playoff baseball afternoons 2 to 6 on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Tigers take a 5-0 lead to the top of the sixth inning along with Jim Price. I'm Dan Dickerson. Tigers and A's have had just about an equal number of base runners, but Nate Robertson has been a magician tonight. Jim, with men on base, men in scoring position, looks like he's on the rope. Inning after inning, he has come up with the big play and solid defense behind it.
Kirk out the side in the fourth, and then looked like in the fifth, more problems, and he gets a double play. And then Craig Monroe with a sensational defensive play to take away an RBI single from Bradley. And you have to say, Dan, after the fourth and fifth inning, the Oakland A's got to be saying, what's going on here? What does it take?
They've had base runners in every inning and two base runners in four of the first five innings and have yet to score. Marcus Thames will lead off for the Tigers. Chad Godin is on the mound and the first pitch is a fastball strike. Jim, we never see evidence of Chad Godin's control problems, do we? I mean, Tigers have not drawn a walk off him this year.
Well, again, we don't walk a lot to begin with, but he does have a good arm. If he can get that fastball under control...
Pitch a little bit low, 2-1.
You'd think he'd have a good future, but they do like his stuff. There's no question about that, and he's shown it good against us.
Seeing activity again, Joe Kennedy, the only lefty in the A's bullpen, up and throwing, swinging a foul off the mask of Kennedy. 1-2 on Marcus Thames. Barry Zito started tonight, retired the first eight in order, and rather easily. And then Brandon Inge drilled a home run to left with two outs in the third. Four more batters reached in that inning to push across another run, and that really was the beginning of the end for Zito. There's a strike on the outside corner, and Marcus Thames is out on strikes, the first strikeout for Chad Godin.
Well, he painted, and once again, that double play in the fifth, another donation to Jack's Place for Autism, donated by Zuber Buick. Don't forget the big event, November 11th. Check out the action for Jack's Place for Autism. JacksPlaceForAutism.com. Honor written in Stevie Eiserman, the captain for the Red Wings. November 11th, that's to Joe.
Brandon Inge at the plate. Godin works from the stretch. Brandon fouls one out of play. Pudge Rodriguez started the fourth with a home run off of Zito, but the big at-bats tonight have belonged to Brandon Inge, especially considering he'd gone 3 for 24. against Barry Zito in his career, because the second time up, he doubled and just missed, hitting a home run. That was in the fourth inning. It also brought home a run. He swings and misses, and a slider from Godin. It's 0-2.
Well, he's got a very good short slider. That's kind of the old-fashioned slider. It's short with a little down to it. Fernando Rodney throwing an R-pen.
Outfield straight up on Brandon. The 0-2 pitch way out of the strike zone with a sweeping breaking ball down and away. 2-for-2 for Brandon. A home run and an RBI double. 5 runs, 7 hits for the Tigers. No errors. No runs, 6 hits, 1 error for the Oakland A's. And it was a big, big error in the fourth. Godin's 1-2 pitch off the plate inside. You can see that he misses that target with that fastball from time to time. You can see that inconsistency, but...
You also see the live action on it, too.
Cool night in Oakland, and the Tigers have a 5-0 lead. The pitch high and outside. Brandon lays off. Game one of the American League Championship Series between the Tigers and the Oakland A's. Their first meeting in 34 years. Boy, Laren LeGros probably gotten a few phone calls this week, hasn't he?
Oh, we nicknamed him Lurch. Laren Lurch LeGros.
3-2 pitch, swinging a soft pop fly into right. That's going to drop for a base hit and hit it off the end of the bat, but he drops it into right. A 3-for-3 night for Brandon Inge.
Good at bat. You have 2 strikes on you, protect the plate, and he did.
Of course, Laren LeGros in game two in relief hit Bert Campaneris. Bert Campaneris then reacted by throwing his bat at a pitcher. I've never seen that before. Have you ever seen that in any other game at any level?
No, I never did, in minor leagues or the big leagues.
It's going to be the end of the night for Chad Godin with a base hit by Brandon Inge. Campaneris ended up getting suspended for the rest of that series, but I remember, Jim, as a kid being outraged that he was allowed to come back for the World Series that year.
Yeah, there was a lot of controversy about that. Really didn't make a lot of sense. Really didn't.
And the Tigers dropped the first two, won the next two, and then dropped game five, the deciding game at home at Tiger Stadium. A's are making a change with a man on and a man out. We're in the sixth inning, and the Tigers have a 5-0 lead. And while the A's make the change, we'll pause for these words on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League titles, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success, your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
Follow the Tigers playoff run with us middays from 10 to 2 on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
Joe Kennedy is the new pitcher for the Oakland A's. He comes in with a man on, a man out, and the Tigers leading 5-0 in the top of the sixth inning.
This is his first action in postseason play during the year. Good job, 4-1 record, a 2.31 ERA. Opponents only batting .254 against him. 29 strikeouts in 35 innings, and less hits than innings pitched. It always catches your eye.
Flip over to first to drive Brandon back. The throw popped right out of the gloves of Nick Swisher, the first baseman. He had to go over to retrieve it as it rolled away. No chance for Brandon to advance. Well, you think that Ken Maka probably right here is trying to either find out a little more about Kennedy or get his confidence up against lefties, because he's the lone lefty in the bullpen. Pitching to the lefty, Granderson, there's a strike, and lefties hit .326 against him this year, and he obviously needs to shut them down.
No question about that. When you only have one lefty, it's like, we've seen this for years, like having no left-handers, really.
You've got to pick your spots in these big games. Here's a ground ball tap slowly to the right side. Now Swisher turns, and there's nobody covering first. And Curtis Granderson is safe, and Brandon Inge is safe at second. Just a little tapper softly to the right side. Swisher got it, turned, no one was there. Jimenez and Kennedy both broke late. And man, oh man, that's got to be an out.
So no question about it. Swisher was kind of in no man's land. He might have been able to get back to the bag if he'd have known no one was going to cover the bag. But when he's wheeled the other way and he looked for somebody, it was too late. Kennedy was late. And Jimenez, there we go again, a second baseman that we were told Mark Ellis is a big loss for this ball club, the regular second baseman.
I mean, the lefty at the plate, your second baseman's got to be a little bit closer to first. Polanco takes a breaking ball a little bit high.
Well, you know, this team swept their series. They won three in a row, and, you know, sometimes you lose the momentum, you lose the sharpness sitting and waiting for the other club.
They gave Granderson a base hit. He'll take it. Second hit of the night. Polanco swings and fouls it over the screen right below us. One ball, one strike. Placido has reached a couple of times. We talked about the importance of those top two men, Granderson and Polanco.
Remember,
this is Oakland A's staff that doesn't give up a lot of base runners.
And it's an Oakland A's team that doesn't make many errors, but that should be an error. It's a mental error, and there should be another category for that.
Emmys.
Yeah, really should be.
Now the lefty, Kennedy delivers. Polanco swings and fouls it back to the screen. He's reached twice with a walk and a big RBI single off of Zito. That was the second to last batter that Zito faced in the fourth. It brought home the fifth run of the game. Granderson has reached twice. So seven trips to the plate, and the top two men have reached four times. That will be very big as this series goes forward. Now the 1-2 to Placido, way off the plate inside. He jackknifes out of the way and then falls across home plate. Two balls, two strikes. Two on and one out, and the Tigers are trying to add to a 5-0 lead that has silenced this crowd in the sixth inning. 35,000 capacity here at Oakland, the Coliseum. Now Polanco again backed away by an inside pitch. And it's a full count on Placido with Casey waiting on deck. There was some thought that the Major League Baseball might have the A's lift some of these tarps off the upper deck to allow them to sell more tickets, but they're adamant to stick by the strategy they adopted at the start of this year, and they want to stick with it, create that demand for tickets. 3-2 pitch, there goes the runner, swinging a fly ball down the left field line that will hook foul into the A's bullpen. Granderson and Inge will have to head back to second and to first. Pitching change is brought to you by New Life. You can change your life today with New Life. If you or someone you know has an addiction to prescription drugs, they can help. Call 866-NULIFE3. Well, let's see if Jim Leland elects to put the runners in motion again. There they go. 3-2 pitch. Ground ball to shortstop. The only play for Scudero is to first. He throws out Polanco. Inge to third. Granderson to second. There were two down now for Sean Casey. So putting the runners in motion keeps the Tigers out of the double play. Casey has also walked and singled. Ordonez with an RBI single. Pudge with a home run. And Brandon Inge with a big 3-for-3. Home run, double, and a single.
They've been a combination of good swings and magician work of Nate Robertson here tonight.
As we watch Rodney throw, do you think he'll just be ready in case Nate gets into further trouble in the sixth, or do you think he'll start?
Boy, I have a feeling maybe we'll say, Nate, that's enough. I mean, you don't know with Jim Leland, but boy.
There's a pitch low and inside to Casey.
Because he knows that Nate's been living very dangerously.
Very dangerously.
It's been amazing. Good defense and stepping up when he's had to, but boy.
Frank Thomas will lead off in the bottom of the sixth. Now Casey takes a breaking ball. That's got some good bite to it. It's a called strike. One ball, one strike.
Well, you watch. Look at Kennedy's stuff. He still has that good arm. 93 with the fastball. Sharp slider.
Well, that slider, he shouldn't get burned by lefties too often, should he?
No.
Guy's been hit by lefties. Pitching to a left-handed batter who has hit lefties well throughout his career, Sean Casey. The 1-1 pitch. Swinging a ground ball up the middle. Scudero will field it. From behind second, he will throw to first. Casey. Oh, man. Sean Casey is limping his way to first base. And that's why Scudero at second actually hesitated before he threw. And then you look down, you realize Casey wasn't even halfway to first base. He pulled something on the way to first. And remember, the Tigers' only backup at first is not Chris Shelton. It is Carlos Guillen. And that looks like the end of the night, certainly, for Sean Casey. And we just hope it's only for tonight. An injury to Casey ends the top of the sixth. The Tigers have a 5-0 lead. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
America's number one sports morning show joins Detroit's number one sports station. Mike and Mike in the Morning comes to 1270XYZ, the sports station. Morning 6 to 10.
Somebody's going to have to come to the table awfully hard to jump into this crew.
Followed by the Sports Inferno with Mike Valenti and Jerry Foster. Middays 10 to 2. The Big Show with Doug Karsh and Art Regner. Afternoons 2 to 6. The Tigers Spotlight with Scott the Gator Anderson. Evenings at 6. Only on 1270XYZ, the sports station.
Buick is filled with the 2007 Buick Rendezvous. GMS lease for current Buick owners. A ton of stock that must be sold. Great deals. $179 a month for 27 months with $19.95 down. Deals like that can be made now, but you must see Zuber Buick. Offer ends October 31st, 2006. See dealer for details now. Call them at 734-946-8112 or visit online at ZuberBuick.com.
What's a Zuber? Everything you want your car to be.
The Office Depot 20th Anniversary Event, and we have great deals to celebrate. This week only, we have our lowest prices ever on select Brother business machines. These deals won't last long, so hurry in to the Office Depot 20th Anniversary Event. Come in, celebrate, and save. While supplies last, assortment may vary by location.
Detroit Tigers playoff baseball on 1270XYT, the sports station, is brought to you by Crittenden Hospital Medical Center, caring professionals committed to excellence.
Well, changes for the Tigers. The A's bat in the bottom of the sixth. The Tigers have a 5-0 lead. With the injury to Sean Casey, pulled something on the way to first base. Carlos Guillen moves from shortstop to first, and Ramon Santiago will take over at short. And as you thought the case might be, Fernando Rodney does indeed start the bottom of the sixth inning.
Well, we both said Nate was the living dangerous. He did a great job, but you just can't keep doing that and getting away with it. So Jim Leland goes to Rodney, well-rested, no action yet in postseason, but during the regular season play, a 1.96 batting average against, an ERA of 3.52. He won 7, lost 4, but just needs to have that command. 34 walks and 71 in 2/3 innings, 65 strikeouts to go with it.
And down the stretch, walks and hit batters really hurt Fernando Rodney. Thomas swings, breaks his bat, pops it up into shallow left center. Late break for Monroe, but he'll make the catch on the run in left center field. Boy, that's a good out to get for him right there. I was about to say, good test for him right off the bat. A very patient hitter at the plate. And in his last 7 appearances, either hit a batter or walked a batter or both, Jim, in his last 7 appearances.
Yeah, and just seemed out of sync with all of his pitches. Just did not have the rhythm going and walked so many people. And, you know, on that play to left field, that pop-up, Curtis Granderson went after two, and he slipped and fell down. So that outfield area where, you know, a lot of worn-out area out there from the football team.
There's a bunt down the third baseline. It's a power bunt off the bat of Jay Payton, and it goes foul. And how about that? Jay Payton trying to lay down a bunt to get his way on. When we watched a replay of Sean Casey, and whatever it was, Jim, it was kind of an unusual replay because he swung the bat, came out of the batter's box, and one step out of the batter's box, he was injured and looking back as if something had reached up and bit him in the back of the ankle. And you just hope it's not an Achilles, and I shouldn't speculate because you just don't know. Hopefully we'll get word. But he was limping very badly when he left the field. Swinging a foul over the screen, 0-2 on Payton.
Well, he'll get our crack training crew up there working on him right away, and hopefully he'll be all right in the rest of this series. But we won't know. We'll hopefully get word and let you all know.
Chris Shelton has been traveling with the team, but he could not replace him until the next series. There's a swing and a line drive hooking down the left field line. It is a fair ball into the corner off the bat of Peyton. Fielding the ball along the wall is Craig Monroe, and Jay Peyton will stop at second with his second double of the night. It came on an 0-2 pitch.
He is a pain in the neck. All year he's been the pain in the neck, and two good swings in this ball game. Remember, a walk and a double by Peyton in the fourth, but Nate Robertson struck out the side, so here we go again.
That brings up Chavez. One for two in this game. Tigers bullpen did an excellent job against the A's this year. The primary setup men, Walker, Rodney, Grilly, and Zamaya combined to pitch 11 innings and gave up just one run against the Oakland A's in nine games this year. Chavez takes a pitch low and inside, and interestingly enough, Todd Jones didn't face the Oakland A's this year in nine games.
That is very strange.
Especially considering the Tigers won five. Left-handed batter with a closed stance. Down near at the plate for Chavez. Finished strong. And he takes the pitch high and outside. That's the changeup away. And boy, we've seen a lot of these tonight. 2-0 count. Both with Nate Robertson and the Oakland starter Zito. Now with Fernando Rodney.
We're getting down there some Maya time. So Leland's hoping that Rodney can give us at least a good inning here.
First appearance of the postseason for Rodney. Faced the A's three innings this year, gave up one run and walked five in the three innings. Here's a pitch way inside, and it's 3-0.
Now Carlos Guillen, now our first sacker. We're going to talk to Rodney. Try to settle him down. It seems like, because that pitch was inside, so many pitches are either inside to a left-handed batter or away from the right-handed batter.
Quick conversation. Guillen heads back to first. 5-0 Tigers with the lead in the bottom of the sixth inning. Glad to have you along for game one of the American League Championship Series between the Tigers and the Oakland A's. Rodney sets, checks Peyton, delivers a fastball that splits the plate for a called strike. Sharp single to center. Struck out his last time up. Nate Robertson, five innings tonight. No runs on six hits, and he walked three. Struck out four, and what a job he did in the fourth. Walk and a double. He struck out Chavez, Swisher, and Scudero. 3-1 pitch, swinging a high foul out of play down the left field line. Monroe will come over, but just to get a closer look at where it lands, 3-2 now on Chavez. You don't picture an inactivity really affecting Fernando Rodney at all, do you?
No, absolutely not. I just think that Jim Leland said, hey, I've got to let him look at some games and try to work on the side, get him back to where we need him to be, and then, you know, bring him in, and hopefully he can regain some confidence, because that's part of it, losing that confidence with your pitchers.
He's going to be a big part if the Tigers are going to win this series. You would think he'll play a big part in it. Especially if it goes six or seven. Now he sets. The payoff pitch to Chavez. Swing and a foul out of play. Upper deck, third base side.
You know, both pitches are so good. And the hitters, you can't, you know, you can't read his changeup. It's fastball arm motion, fastball body motion. And we see it time and time again. It's just the hitters laying off the pitches that, for the most part, gets him in trouble.
And I would think you could go out there looking for the changeup sometime and still be fooled.
Really, yes, absolutely. You know, it dances. It moves all over the place.
Now Rodney has the sign. Pudge setting up outside. 3-2 pitch to Chavez. Inside. Too far. Ball four. He walks it.
Here we go again.
Two base runners in every inning except the second for the Oakland A's. And this... It'd be very difficult to go through a full game like this. Eventually, it's going to bite you. Nate Robertson worked out of trouble thanks to three double play ground balls and that tremendous job of striking out the side with runners at second and third. Now the infield will come in. A little pep talk for Fernando Rodney from Polanco and Santiago, the double play combination. Hutch came out from behind home plate, a pat on the back. And now back behind home plate. One pitch, and Fernando Rodney got Frank Thomas on a broken bat fly ball to left. But then Peyton doubled on an 0-2 pitch. Chavez walked.
sixth inning today, brought to you by Dunham Sports. Get in the game at Dunham. Now Swisher at the plate. Switch batter batting lefty. Swing and a miss. Starts him off with a fastball that was clocked at 97 on the gun here at the Oakland Coliseum.
That was an angry heater.
Hinges off the line, deep at third. Santiago and Polanco in double play depth. Santiago, the new shortstop, shades up the middle with Swisher hitting from the left side. Good power from both sides for Swisher. Again, the average a little higher from the right side. And he struck out at a much higher rate as a left-handed batter. Struck out twice from the right side against Nate Robertson. Midway in the left-handed batter's box, knees bent, cocks the bat tight over his left shoulder. Rodney works from the third base side of the rubber. He sets the 0-1 pitch, swing and a foul straight back. 0-2 on Swisher.
Stayed with the fastballs. Boy, I tell you, he sells that changeup because the way he extends that arm with the fastball, and he extends the arm the same way with the changeup. Nothing changes. It's just the command that gets him in trouble.
Boy, as a hitter, it's got to be an awful feeling when he's gotten to 0-2 with fastball to just have that changeup in the back of your mind. Two on, one out. Tigers lead 5-0. Rodney's 0-2 pitch, swinging a high pop-up. Shallow right field. Polanco calling for it. He'll make the catch in front of Maglio Ordonez. He got him with a changeup. Little pop fly to right. Polanco makes the catch in shallow right field for out number two. Two on, two outs now for Marco Scudero. He's bounced into a double play and taken a called third strike. That ended the A's best scoring chance in the fourth inning. Well, we've heard chants of Marco Scudero every time he's been up. Those who've been here for a long time said they've never heard any other player, Jim, had his name chanted here at the Coliseum. Isn't that something? That the first would be Marco Scudero.
And it's amazing. I mean, you're basically a utility player and all the great players they've had here.
Right-handed batter, deep in the right-handed batter's box. First pitch is low and outside.
I mean, you look at the history of this ball club with Reggie Jackson. My goodness, come on.
You'd think somewhere along the line that would have happened. Scudero will turn 31 later this month. A waiver claim from the New York Mets. He's played a very valuable role filling in recent years for injured players like Ellis and Crosby. Ground ball foul right by Ron Washington. And Billy Bean says all the credit goes to his former assistant, John D. Podesta, walked into his office one day in October after the season, said, I'd like to get this guy off waivers. And Billy Bean said, I was a little busy. I looked up and said, okay, kid, go get him.
And he did, and the rest is history.
Whatever you want to do. Pretty good pickup off waivers. 2-1 and 2 out. The 1-1 count on Scudero. Rodney delivers high and outside. And tried to get a little extra, and it's 2-1. Rodney, one of the more deliberate workers you will watch, with bases empty, men on, it doesn't matter. He'll take that little saunter to the side of the mound, take a big deep breath, and then plant that foot on the right side of the rubber. Scudero fairly upright stands, 2-1 pitch, swinging a ground ball wide to third, nice hop for Brandon Inge. Down to Polanco for the force on Chavez, and once again, the Tigers work out of trouble. Five innings, the A's have had two men on out of the six, and they have yet to score. We've played six innings in Oakland. It's the Tigers 5 and the A's nothing on the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
Going head-to-head with batters for eight innings can really fatigue a pitcher. That's the time to bring in your closer. As a facilities manager or contractor, you may also need last-minute support. For fast backup, call on Granger. With 24/7 online ordering, tens of thousands of products in stock, and one-stop convenience, Granger gives you fast access to everything from motors to lighting supplies. Count on Granger's knowledgeable staff to put you in a winning position. Granger, for the ones who get it done.
When you see the blue Old English D, you always think of the Detroit Tigers. And when you see the familiar Blue Cross and Shield, you always think of quality health care. Two great symbols, two great institutions, one great state. The Tigers have been here since 1901, winning games, winning pennants, and winning our hearts. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan has been here since 1939, ensuring that every man, woman, and child in the state of Michigan has access to affordable, quality health care. And like the Tigers, they're here to stay. The Tigers have given the people of Michigan a lot of memorable moments. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan wishes the Tigers all the best in their drive to the championship. Because they believe in the Tigers. Because they believe in Michigan. Because Michigan is their home. Blue Cross Blue Shield of Michigan is a nonprofit corporation and independent licensee of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association.
Detroit Tigers Playoff Baseball on 1270 XYT, the sports station, is brought to you by Comerica. We listen, we understand, we make it work.
Follow the Tigers playoff run every afternoon from 2 to 6 on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Bat at the top of the seventh inning, and they've got a 5-0 lead over the Oakland A's in the first of two here in Oakland to start this best of seven series. We'll be home Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at Comerica Park. Looking forward to seeing the atmosphere there after what we witnessed last weekend. That was something special. New pitcher for the Oakland A's, Kiko Calero, takes over on the mound in a 5-0 game. Tigers on top.
This right-hander picked up his first postseason career win. The second game against the Minnesota Twins. One inning and shut him down with a walk and a strikeout. And overall during the season, did a very good job. 58 innings, only 50 hits. Four home runs. He walked 24. Struck out 67 with a batting average against of 231.
Lot to like about the setup men for Houston Street. Here's a ground ball wide to third. Backing up to play the big hop is Chavez. Throw to first. They just get Ordonez. He knew exactly how quickly he had to field the ball. One pitch, one out here in the seventh inning. Dukeshire and Calero have both been big setup men for Houston Street. Calero, a late bloomer, came over with Danny Heron in the Mark Mulder trade with the St. Louis Cardinals. Didn't really get a chance until he was in his late 20s. He put down roots at Double-A Wichita. Five straight years at Double-A, going from his mid-20s to his late 20s, probably wondering if he was ever going to get a chance. And boy, he's been rock steady once he got to the major league.
Yeah, it really has. And, you know, this bullpen is good. They don't have the flamethrowers, but they have the guys that can do the job with a variety of pitches.
Now Carlos Guillen at the plate, and he takes a strike right at the belt on the inside corner. 0 for 3 for Carlos Guillen. And actually, Jim, you kind of like the fact that the Tigers have built this lead without their most consistent and their best hitter, Carlos Guillen. As you know, he's going to have big games in this series. There's a breaking ball strike on the inside corner. He was 8 for 14 in the series of the Yankees with two walks. So 16 plate appearances, and he reached 10 times.
The other thing you like is only one Tiger has struck out tonight while we picked up three base on balls. So to me, that shows that good swings carrying over from the Yankee series.
The 0-2 pitch, swing and a little tap foul over by the Tigers dugout. No word yet on Sean Casey. And really, you just keep your fingers crossed and hope that it's something that he can recover from quickly.
Well, I tell you, though, that cool night like tonight, trying to get out of the batter's box. Something happened. We don't know what it is.
One step, and he had to stop coming out of the batter's box. The 0-2 high and off the glove of Kendall, right back to the screen behind home plate. Pudge Rodriguez waiting on deck. Top three, Granderson, Polanco, and Casey have all reached twice tonight. Granderson with a couple of hits. Polanco and Casey each with a walk and a single. Rodriguez and Inge have the home runs, and Brandon Inge has a 3-for-3 night going. 5-0 Tigers with the lead, the 1-2 pitch. Just off the plate, apparently outside. Wow, is that close?
There have been some difference of opinions as far as the calls by the home plate umpire here tonight.
35,000 tend to disagree with some of these calls, but it's a 2-2 count. Calero delivers, swinging a foul out of play. Guillen just wasted a pitch off the plate, wasn't taking a chance on that one. He's bounced out twice and popped out. Two against the starter Zito, and then against the reliever Godin. still more activity down in the A's bullpen.
Now pitch a little bit high. Is that Blanton down there
that
throwing?
It is. Dealt with that body and the pants pulled up below his knees. Gives you that first indication, the body.
He's the odd man out in the rotation for the Oakland A's. Pretty tough after you win 16.
Right.
They get dropped from the rotation, but they elected to go with Harden over Blanton. Oh, Carlos has bounced back. 3-2 pitch. Swinging a line drive. Base hit into right field. That's just a quality at-bat by Carlos Guillen. Fell behind 0-2, and on the eighth pitch of the at-bat is sharp single to right.
Well, he's such a patient hitter. You make the mistake, he makes you pay. I mean, he fouled off a good pitch, but that was a hanging breaking ball. He didn't miss it with that line drive stroke of his.
Brings up Pudge Rodriguez, 1-for-3 tonight. He hit a home run the opposite way over the 388 mark. That's the high part of the wall in right center field. The National League most valuable player in the National League Championship Series when he was with the Marlins in 03. And he's off to a good start in his first return to a championship series with the Tigers. Now Calero delivers a strike. He painted the outside corner with a fastball in above the knees. Strike one on Pudge. 10th hit of the night for the Tigers, a single from Carlos Guillen. His first hit of the night. Pudge looks down at third base coach Gene Lamont. Now he gets ready to dig back in. Calero works from the third base side of the rubber, turns over his left shoulder to take a look at Carlos Guillen, who's got a short lead at first. The pitch to Pudge, breaking ball in the dirt. Kendall did a much better job throwing out runners this year than last year, and I think credit goes to the Oakland A's pitchers. They seem to pay a little more attention to those runners on first.
Catchers, it's like a quarterback and their lineman. It's the same way with a catcher and their pitchers. You help me, I'll take you to dinner. Especially all the money he's making.
And when you see big yearly jumps, right, that's right. When you look at the pitching.
Right.
Middle of the infield, double play depth. Kendall setting up outside. Calero's 1-1 pitch, swinging a pop foul, and that was not where he wanted that pitch. It hung out over home plate, but Pudge fouled it off. 1-2. Cool night. Temperatures have dropped into the upper 50s. We're in the mid-60s at game time, but last night I think the temperature took a big drop when the sun went down. Bigger than tonight.
Yes, I think it's a little better tonight. Especially tucked in like we are.
We're protected. There's no question about it. Right-handed batter against the righty, Kiko Calero. 1-2, a man on, a man out, and the Tigers up by 5. The pitch, swinging a line drive into right. That's going to drop for a base hit. Bradley over to field it on one hop. Guillen will have to hold it second. Bradley's got a good arm. Back-to-back singles. The Tigers have a threat here in the seventh inning. And, Jim, this is what we've seen throughout these playoffs. The ability for the Tigers to score early in the game, but still have good at-bats throughout the course of the game. The bats don't go silent like we saw so often during the regular season.
And the way we played against the Yankees, we've done everything right. We've done everything right here again tonight. We have going the other way with pitches away. That's what Rodriguez did there with the slider away from him. Did not try to pull the ball. Carlos Guillen in front of him got a hanging slider. Same type of swing. The control swings are much better. Much better in this postseason action for the Tigers.
And brings up Craig Monroe, and the first pitch is low and outside, and he's 0-2 plus a walk. Brandon Inge talking about how he just noticed that from the first at-bat, being in the playoffs has a tendency to make you concentrate just a little more. There's no drifting.
No.
There might be.
During the regular season.
During a 162-game season. It's low and outside. You can say that shouldn't happen, but let's face it, you're human.
You're human, and listen, the focus, it's hard to focus 100% all the time. You go into spurts, and, you know, mentally it gets you down. You talk to yourself, you answer yourself, and, you know, you try to limit those bad spurts. But now it's payoff time.
Two on, one out. The pitch to Monroe, swing and a foul back to the screen. 2-1. Tigers trying to add to a 5-0 lead. The A's have had scoring chances throughout the night. But Tigers pitchers, Nate Robertson and Fernando Rodney, have come up with
big pitches when they had to. And there's nobody throwing in the Tigers' bullpen, so Fernando will come out to start the bottom of the seventh.
I think Jim Leland liking this lead, 5-0. Says I'm going to give Rodney a little work. I'm going to save Samaya. We'll have Verlander and gang ready for tomorrow.
Loaiza against Verlander is the matchup, and that's an intriguing matchup tomorrow in game two. Now Calero checks the runner, delivers Zhu a breaking ball strike on the outside corner. That outside corner to a right-handed batter especially is
wide,
favorable for pitchers tonight. Scudero and Jimenez, the double play combination, looking for something on the ground right here. Chavez is deep and off the line at third. The outfield straight up. They don't move a whole lot in this ballpark. Now Calero sets. The 2-2 on its way. There go the runners, swinging a high pop-up to right, and the runners will have to hustle back. Camping under it is Bradley. He'll make the catch. Back to second goes Guillen. Back to first goes Pudge. They're there with two down now for Marcus Thym.
We want to pass along our condolences to Dwayne McClain, who's the Senior Vice President of Business Operations for the Detroit Tigers. His mother-in-law passed away recently, and it's a tough time for that family, and our thoughts to go out to Dwayne McClain and his family, and well, we just want them all to know that all of us out here, our thoughts are with you.
Now, Timms digs in. 0 for 3 tonight. He did score a run after reaching in a fielder's choice. Swing and a miss. Slider down and away. Boy, the A's have had Marcus's number this year. Just 1 for 26 against Oakland pitching this year. That one hit was a home run. 0 for 3 tonight. There weren't many teams that had his number quite like that. Now a swing and a miss. Again, the slider down and away, and he's quickly down 0-2.
Remember, we've seen him hit pitches not that far off the plate away from it. We know he likes to extend those arms, and how many times have we seen him take a pitch off the plate away out of the ballpark?
Again, takes his lead off second, Pudge off of first. Tigers trying to add to a 5-0 lead. The 0-2 pitch, he bounces a curveball up the home plate. Breaking ball off the plate. 1-2 on Marcus. Had some big at-bats in the Yankees series. 5 for 15. 3 of those hits against Mike Mussina.
Well, so far in this postseason, we have played like we did a good part of the first half of the season, where we were crisp. Our steps seemed a little bit quicker than the other teams, led by pitching. But we did all the small things and also hit some bombs.
1-2 pitch here, high and outside.
You know, a lot of people say, are you in that streak again? It certainly looks like we're in that streak where the guys are playing with so much confidence.
Consistency of the at-bats, inning to inning, batter to batter, has been impressive. Now, Thym's waiting on a 2-2 pitch, on its way, swing and a foul. Well, he wasn't going to take a chance at the slider down and away. He just wasted it right off the end of the bat. He still has life. Again, singled with one out. Pudge followed with a base hit to right. On the hit and run, Monroe hit a little fly ball to right. Now Marcus trying to come through with a big hit with two outs. Tigers scored some big two-out runs in the third after Barry Zito had retired the first 8 batters he faced. 5 in a row reached, and the Tigers had an early 2-0 lead. Now Calero's 2-2 pitch, swinging a high pop-up on the right side. Jimenez, the second baseman on the outfield grass, will make the catch, and the Tigers threaten but do not score. Seventh inning stretch in Oakland, and the Tigers have a 5-0 lead. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
If you work on your car, one thing you should know, a man named Murray is going to save you some dough.
Okay, so you know that Murray's Discount Auto Stores are the auto parts supermarket with clean wide aisles and the largest selection of parts and accessories in town. But did you also know that when the going gets tough, it's time to get down to your friendly Murray's Discount Auto Store and ask for help? Our parts professionals have what you need to get the job done, and they'll steer you right at guaranteed low prices. So now that you know, remember this.
A man named Murray is going to save you some dough.
Nobody goes to an emergency room when they're feeling good. You're in pain. You need a doctor. But instead, you're doing paperwork, rereading old magazines, and sitting on a hard plastic chair. What a pain in the butt. There's got to be a better way to get better. At the ERs of the DMC, home of the 29-minute ER guarantee, many butts never even hit the chair. As soon as you come in, you're into America's best emergency care. With nationally known doctors, industry-leading accreditations, and off-the-chart patient satisfaction scores, every other ER in Metro Detroit takes a back seat on a hard plastic chair. To Detroit Receiving, Sinai Grace, Huron Valley, Michigan Orthopedics, and Children's, the ERs of the DMC, a better way to get better. For more details, visit dmc.org or call 1-888-DMC-2500 to schedule an appointment.
Hey, everybody, this is Greeny.
Hey, Mike Golick here. Catch the hometown call of every Tigers playoff game only on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Take a 5-0 lead to the bottom of the seventh inning. God bless America. Just swung here at the Oakland Coliseum, and now everybody on their feet singing, "Take Me Out to the Ball Game." It's been all Tigers tonight. Two runs in the third inning gave them the early lead against Barry Zito, and then three big runs in the fourth. The A's have had their scoring chances all night long. Two runners on in five of the six innings. Nate Robertson escaped. And so did Fernando Rodney in his first inning of work last inning. And Fernando Rodney is back on the mound. The Tigers bullpen, you would assume, on high alert as we go into the bottom of the seventh inning. The Tigers' relief work has been brilliant in the first four games of the postseason, plus the one inning for Fernando Rodney here tonight. And that really, I think Jim has given them the edge over the Yankees, and now perhaps going into this series, it's very evenly matched, but perhaps a slight edge over the A's in this series.
Yeah, it could be, but, you know, we have those power arms that kind of the old equalizer, you know, and you can bring in Zamaya and Rodney with those type of arms. It's not many teams have that situation. And, you know, we looked at this game, how they had so many opportunities to score, and you say you bring in Rodney with that good fastball and change up, and again, take more out of this team, and perhaps you can, you know, have it lean on over till tomorrow, like I think we saw in the Yankees series.
Nice big get, two scoreless innings out of Fernando Rodney. You would think probably just one for Zamaya, one for Jones.
You would think so. But Nate Robertson, you tip your hat to him. It was a tough five innings, but they kept him off the board, and that's the main thing. And he was tough when he had to be, and that inning, that fourth inning, was spectacular when he struck out the side with two on and nobody down. It was just spectacular.
Amazing how he comes up with those pitches after. I mean, he's been struggling locating home plate at times, and he just bore down and got three good hitters with some incredibly tough pitches.
You know, you kid with Nate, you know, about being a bulldog and about how he does that. He just threads it off and just, well, I don't know. I just dig a little bit deeper, you know, and sometimes they help me, sometimes I get them.
There's a piece of the foam padding that fell off the wall in foul territory down the left field line, and they're repairing that right now, and that's one of the reasons we are having a holdup here before the bottom of the seventh inning. Until they get that reattached, we will not have a ball put in play just in case the ball were to go down into that corner. D'Angelo Jimenez will lead off here in the bottom of the seventh inning, followed by Kendall and Kotze. Kotze has led the way for the offense tonight. Two walks and a single. He's reached three times, and Payton with a couple of doubles has had the best swings of the night. Right now, you think they just get the duct tape out and
Get
that baby to the railing.
We've got some tape up here we can send down, and probably have a chance to let everybody know that you can live out your baseball dreams with the Tigers Fantasy Camp. You can suit up in January and play alongside former Tigers right at the Tigertown Complex. Call 313-471-2550 or log on to Tigers.com and join the really great fantasy campers. They have a big heart, and there are a lot of terrific folks.
There's a strike from Fernando Rodney to Jimenez starting off the seventh inning. D'Angelo Jimenez, 1-for-2, singled off of Nate Robertson to start the fifth inning. Every inning except the second, the A's have had two base runners on, no more, no less. Often with a walk and a hit. There's a pitch in the dirt with a changeup, 1-ball, 1-strike. Jimenez did not have much success in his limited at-bats this year, first with Texas and then with the Oakland A's, 71 at-bats and a 180 batting average. Ends even the base at third, rest of the infield back. The outfield plays him shallow, and they play him to go the opposite way. There's a check swing. He went too far. No need for Jerry Crawford, the home plate umpire, to appeal. He goes up with the right hand. 1-2 on Jimenez.
What he has, Duke throw strikes, challenge to his hitters, 5-0. Deep in the game.
First action of the postseason for Fernando Rodney. Works from the stretch from the third base side of the rubber. He kicks and delivers a little bit high. Boy, is that close. With a changeup, 2-2.
Sometimes the umpires are cool. Did you see that late movement on it from the changeup? It dances at times. That kind of went down and away from the hitter. Sometimes the umpires give up on him also.
Jimenez bends at the waist out over the plate. The 2-2 pitch way out of the strike zone with a fastball. This is not a guy you want to walk. You have to make this guy put the ball in play. He's a pretty free swinger. Open stance from the left side for Jimenez. Waiting on the payoff pitch from Rodney. On its way, swinging a high foul out of play. The A's are just hoping that Jimenez will give them solid defensive work. They're really not expecting much offensively, but defensively he's been a little bit shaky tonight with an error and a failure to cover first base on a slow bouncer right to the right side.
One physical error, one mental error.
Now Rodney sets. 3-2 pitch. Strike three called. Got him on the inside corner. Jimenez was headed down to first, thinking he'd drawn a leadoff walk. Instead, Jerry Crawford rings him up.
Well, we just talked about the movement on his changeup. That was almost like a swing back changeup. Completely fooled the hitter. Started inside and swung back over the inner half of the plate. Or at least close to it, anyway.
Close enough. That brings up Jason Kendall, the catcher and leadoff man, right-handed batter against the righty Fernando Rodney, who is tough against righties and lefties this year. First pitch, a fastball, he pours it right through the heart of the plate for a called strike. Loaiza for the A's tomorrow, Verlander for the Tigers. Verlander made three quality starts against the A's this year. Was 1-1, but boy, we saw some great stuff from him against the A's. There's a pitch up and in. And Loaiza, of course, has had success against the Tigers throughout his career. Remember, the first three pitchers in each rotation would be the three that would possibly all make two starts if the series were to go seven games. Robertson, Verlander, and Rogers for the Tigers. There's a swing and a number off the end of the bat. It's going to hug the line to first. Bobble by Guillen, and he can't pick it up. Oh, my goodness. A slow roller to first. Guillen right there by the bag, and he somehow couldn't handle it. And then when he reached, he still had time. He still couldn't come up with it. And Kendall will be safe at first on the very unusual error by Carlos Guillen.
Well, listen, it is an error. There's no doubt about it. He hit it right off the end of the bat. That had some hot spin on it. Hot spin on it. When it hit his glove, it bounced right at it. It was still a hot potato because it had that spin on it. It was a heck of a pitch by Rodney to get him hit off the end of the bat. How that stayed fair, that's another question.
He still had time to reach the ball and reach back to his right.
Right, but again, it had a lot of rotation on it, a lot of hot spin. Should have been an easy play, but couldn't corral it.
So again, the A's have a man on with one out. There's the pitch a little low. Let's pause briefly for station identification on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
The Big Show, afternoons 2 to 6, only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station, WXYZ Detroit, a CBS radio station.
Tatsy, the batter, 1-for-3 in this game, an infield base hit. He swings and fouls one out of play. One ball, one strike. Joel Zamaya has grabbed a ball, and he is now throwing in that Tigers bullpen. Talked about the rotation for the Tigers. The A's, Loaiza tomorrow after Zito started today, and then they really don't know if it'll be Harden or Heron in game three.
I think they're leaning towards Heron.
Yep.
I think that's how they're leaning.
Certainly seemed like that's what it was, yeah. And then read about some indecisiveness. There's a pitch low and in, but likely Heron in three, and Rich Harden, who did not get a chance to pitch in the opening round and has only made three starts since his injury, would start game four.
Whether he went down, he pitched yesterday in the instructional league and banged up pretty good. And, of course, I caught pitchers when I was in the minor leagues, came down on rehab. They're not throwing all out. They're just trying to get some rhythm and throw the ball over the plate. And maybe too much store was put in what happened to him yesterday.
2-1 pitch, swinging a high slicing foul down the left field line. Monroe coming over, but that will get about three rows out of his reach. 2-2 now, the count on Mark Kotze, the Tigers leading 5-0 in the bottom of the seventh inning.
But it's another, we're talking about one of the really good arms in the game, young arms in the game, Harden, and think about Crosby and Ellis. This is a team that's amazing resilience. I mean, even though we're leading in this game, it's a long way from being over, not just this game, but, of course, the series.
Another ball has gotten away from Joe Blanton in that A's bullpen. The bullpen mounds are positioned so that if you throw one away, the ball goes right onto the field of play, and the ball that he just threw onto the field of play wrapped around the wall all the way out to deep left center where Craig Monroe had to get it and flip it into the stands.
Spent some time in the bullpen here, and you're right amongst the crowd. It gets a little noisy, and
they're on you.
Let's just say they could be kind of nasty at times.
Alcotze waiting in a 2-2 pitch, midway in the left-handed batter's box, fairly upright stance. Pitch from Rodney, ground ball to first. He in has it. Down to second one. Santiago's relay back to Rodney. Double play! Carlos Guillen starts a 3-6-1 double play, and that atones for the error after 7 in Oakland. It's the Tigers 5 and the A's nothing on the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
What size work boots do you wear? Do a number and a letter come to mind, like 10D, for instance, or just a number? Red Wing shoes come in hundreds of different sizes and widths, because that's where feet come in. And for our customers, that means more comfortable feet and a more comfortable shift. Hey, size and width do matter. Red Wing shoes, built to fit, built to last, since 1905.
Size does matter. Red Wing shoes with locations in Lansing, Holt, Grand Rapids, Saginaw, and 9 Metro Detroit stores.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League pennants, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success. Your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness in the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
Hey, Tigers fans, this is Iron Mike. Remember to listen for Iron Mike's Iron Man of the Game Award at the end of the game. Call me at 877-IRON-MIKE or log on to 877-IRON-MIKE.com.
Hey, it's Greeny. Catch the Tigers in the ALCS and Mike and Mike in the Morning, only on 1270 XYTV Sports Station.
Tigers bat at the top of the eighth inning. Dan Dickerson and Jim Price from the Oakland Coliseum. 5-0, Tigers with the lead. And Joe Blanton, who was in the rotation all season long, now takes over on the mound. He's working out of the bullpen in these playoffs.
Well, this is first postseason action. Tough time against the Tigers this year. 16 to third innings, 28 hits and 15 earned runs, only 4 strikeouts. And very hittable during the year. A .309 batting average during the regular season. And very hittable, and you understand why he was taken out of the rotation in this series, because you give up that many hits, you walk 58 and 194 in the third inning, you give up 241 hits, that's a lot of folks on base.
Brandon Inge, single, double, home run. He needs a triple for the cycle. He takes the pitch inside. Tough ballpark to get it because there just isn't a whole lot of room in the outfield. Now he takes a pitch in the dirt. Blanton, four more wins than last year, but, well, can you say run support?
Just,
because the ERA went up by almost a run and a half. Here's a pitch up and in, and it's quickly 3-0 on Brandon Inge. Last year he gave up a lot fewer hits than innings pitched at a 3.50 ERA. Now the 3-0 to Brandon. Off the plate inside, he walked him on four pitches. Brandon, 3-for-3, reaches with a leadoff walk here in the eighth inning.
Well, after the first two innings and the fifth inning, we've done damage and we've put pressure on every inning outside of those three in this ballgame. It looks like we can do it again.
Top of the eighth inning brought to you by Bud Light. 5-0, Tigers with the lead, trying to get the jump on the A's in this best-of-seven American League Championship Series. First two games in Oakland, games 3, 4, and 5 in Detroit. There's a strike at the knees. Granderson 2-for-4 tonight. Doubled and scored a run in the two-run third. And then an infield base hit in the sixth inning, really a misplay. He just bounced one to the right side. Swisher fielded it. No one was covering first. Into the short lead at first. Now Curtis takes a pitch off the plate outside. One ball, one strike. Polanco waiting on deck. Inge and Pudge Rodriguez with home runs. Again, we see an early home run jumpstart the Tigers' offense. Ordonez in game 4 in Detroit and Brandon Inge here tonight. Blanton will turn and throw to first. Blanton, part of the Moneyball draft in 2002 that was so highlighted, and a fine book written about the Oakland A's philosophy. And there's a breaking ball strike on the inside corner. One ball, two strikes, first round pick. Native of Tennessee, Blanton did a fine job last year, but now working out of the bullpen after a 16-win season because, as Jim mentioned, an awful lot of hits given up. Ground ball weakly to the right side. Jimenez has it down to second, and they'll just get the lead man, Brandon Inge, the fielder's choice. Granderson safe at first with one out for Placido Polanco.
Well, then you look at him, you know, as far as a number one pick, and nothing against him, but doesn't look like he has that number one pick arsenal. I mean, you know, that average fastball, you know, there isn't one pitch that you say, well, it's lights out with this certain pitch. So sometimes you pick the right person, sometimes you don't. But if you make your number one pick, they have got to be a solid, solid type player.
Excellent rookie year, but didn't follow it up this year, so going forward, you would think a bit of a question mark.
And, you know, with Harden, with the problems he's having, is he ever going to be healthy? He's had problems off and on for some time, but he has a golden arm.
Polanco takes a pitch low and outside. And he really is an X factor in this series, assuming he'll start game 4, not game 3. He'd only get the one start, but boy, if he has it together on that day, whenever we've seen him, he's been
lights
awfully
out.
Tough. Middle of the infield, double play depth. The pitch to Polanco is hit hard to center field. Going back is Kotze. He'll make the catch, racing back to his right. Retreating to first is Granderson. Polanco hit it hard, but right at Kotze. Two down now in the eighth inning with the Tigers leading 5-0. We're getting word that Sean Casey has a left calf injury. And, Jim, that can be anything from a couple of days to a few weeks to more.
With no report on how serious it is, you won't know probably for a day or two.
Now Ramon Santiago, his first at-bat of the postseason, swings and misses at a changeup. Santiago came in when Casey went out because the Tigers' backup first baseman is the shortstop, Carlos Guillen. Switch batter batting from the left side against the righty Joe Blanton. Two outs and a man on first. The strike one pitch is in the dirt. One ball, one strike. Ramon came back, gave the Tigers some good at-bats down the stretch. Whenever he got a chance to play, seems like he started to put the ball in play with some regularity.
We like his actions, you know. He's smooth. He is, you know, he's not one of these guys who's going to hit the ball 9 miles, but he's got good baseball ability.
Takes a pitch high and outside here, and he's got a good hitter's count, 2-1. Zito started tonight, and the Tigers, for the first time ever, knocked him out before the sixth inning, and today they knocked him out in the fourth. He's gone six innings or more in every one of his 14 starts against the Tigers in his career until tonight. 2-1 pitch, fly ball, shallow right field. Bradley drifts into his right. He'll make the catch, and the Tigers get a walk, but no more here in the eighth inning. Bottom of the eighth coming up in Oakland. Tigers 5 and the A's nothing. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
America's number one sports morning show joins Detroit's number one sports station. Mike and Mike in the Morning comes to 1270 XYZ, the sports station. Morning 6 to 10.
Somebody's going to have to come to the table awfully hard to jump into this crew.
Followed by the Sports Inferno with Mike Valenti and Jerry Foster. Middays 10 to 2. The Big Show with Doug Karsh and Art Regner. Afternoons 2 to 6. The Tiger Spotlight with Scott the Gator Anderson. Evenings at 6. Only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
It begins with a slow dance of turning leaves and crescendos in a trillion trees aflame. For the next several weeks, the curtain rises on the greatest show on earth as the 19 million acres of woods called Michigan slowly explode in a frenzy of color. The show plays along every stretch of highway and coastline in every city and town. Admission is free. And great seats are available everywhere. We can go to the movies this weekend. We can stay home and watch TV. Or we can get up, get out, and go see something we'll remember for the rest of our lives. An entire state in its annual blaze of glory. This show is appropriate for all ages. This show is pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
The cooler weather is here. How's that furnace working? Is it keeping you warm efficiently? Call your local Lennox dealer to have it checked out. Call KTM Heating and Cooling at 586-598-8146.
Bottom of the eighth in the Oakland Coliseum, and the Tigers have a 5-0 lead in game one of the ALCS with the Oakland A's. Nate Robertson, 5 shutout innings, in and out of trouble. Fernando Rodney, 2 shutout innings, in and out of trouble. And now Joel Zamaya comes on in the bottom of the eighth inning to try to set up Todd Jones for the ninth.
2 innings, 3 strikeouts. We'll never forget those first 3 batters he fanned in New York in his first ever postseason action, but kind of what you expect. He struck out 97 and 83 in a third inning. Batting average gets 187. He walked 42, but an electric arm. And we'll see here if the radar gun can go up over 100.
5 batters in New York, and it may have changed that series. Because the Yankees suddenly realized they were in a fight with the Tigers and the pitching that they could bring out of that bullpen especially. Struck out Jeter, Giambi, and A-Rod in a 5-batter sequence. Ground ball and a shattered bat. The ground ball goes foul, and Milton Bradley has got some hurting hands down there at home plate.
That bat is everywhere. I mean everywhere. And what's interesting, the alert bat boy was very close. He must have figured he's going to get his bat shattered because he hardly left home plate. He had a new bat in his hand. I mean, that's the fastest recovery of a new bat I've ever seen. I mean, that bat went everywhere, and I'm telling you, folks, in another instant, he had a new bat in his hand.
Zamaya from the stretch, the strike one pitch, pulled hard and foul down the right field line. And you talk about a guy who is, well, as Jim Leland likes to put it, charging on the fastball. Bradley was all over a 99-mile-an-hour fastball. Pulled it foul, swinging early. And that's where Zamaya needs to have that off-speed pitch. Bradley, the switch batter, batting lefty. The 0-2 pitch here is swinging a fly ball to center field deep. Granderson going back, and that one is off the wall. Comes back and fields it off the carom, and cruising into second is Milton Bradley with a leadoff double here in the eighth inning on an 0-2 pitch.
Boy, absolutely smoked it, and Well, like you said in Leland's comment, he's all over fastballs, and he pulled one foul, and then he got another one knee high and off the wall in the deepest part of left center field. So some nights we have seen good swings against this overpowering fastball, but it hasn't happened a lot.
Todd Johnson, have a quick word. Arm around the waist of Joel Zamaya, pats him on the back before he gets back behind home plate. 5-0 Tigers. We're in the bottom of the eighth inning. Zamaya got one other batter in that New York series, just a one batter appearance. Those are his two appearances so far in the postseason. Now pitch low and outside. Starts Frank Thomas off with a 100-mile-an-hour fastball down and away.
Remember, Joel's had some time off, so got a lot of adrenaline going. He wants to show the folks in California what he can do.
Big Frank 0 for 2 plus a walk tonight. The pitch from Zamaya, fastball above the belt, but a called strike. Jerry Crawford goes up with a right hand. Outfield deep and straight up. Tremendous comeback season for Frank Thomas, even if he wasn't the comeback player of the year. That went to Jim Thome. Two worthy candidates. The 1-1 pitch, breaking ball, buckled the knees of Frank Thomas, but he lays off, and it's ball two.
He will get better with that breaking ball. That was a pretty good breaking ball, but as time goes on, he will get better with his other pitches.
23 of Frank Thomas's home runs came here at home of his 39. Swing and a miss here. Whoa, he spun him around in that right-handed batter's box. 2-2. Zamaya will take a walk to the side of the mound before he climbs back up on the rubber. He works from the first base side. Bradley at second base with a leadoff double. Base runners in every inning for the Oakland A's tonight, and in most innings, too. But they have yet to score off Tigers pitching. Zamaya sets, holds the glove just above the belt, takes a long look at Bradley. Now the 2-2 pitch, ooh, outside, way out of the strike zone. A 102-mile-an-hour fastball.
Sometimes,
very patient hitter at the plate, 3-2.
Sometimes he tries to overthrow, and that's when he gets himself in trouble. It hasn't happened a lot, but sometimes that radar gun becomes too important to him.
The crowd hasn't had much to cheer about tonight. Making some noise now for their Oakland A's. Zamaya set. 3-2 pitch. Check, swing, bouncer, foul. Probably would have been ball four. Came up and in, and Frank Thomas turned out of the way and went off his bat. Still a 3-2 count. Peyton with a couple of doubles is waiting on deck. Tigers protecting a 5-0 lead in the bottom of the eighth inning. Now Zamaya's 3-2 pitch. There goes the runner swinging the ground ball to short. Right to Santiago. He'll plant, throw. You don't have to hurry. Oh, he almost pulled Guillen off first, but Thomas is out. Over to third goes Bradley. He's there with one out now for Peyton.
Hit it hard, but right at the shortstop. And see what Zamaya can do to take care of these other fellas.
Peyton 2-for-3. He's been a pain in the neck for the Tigers this year. Doubled off of Nate Robertson, then he doubled off of Fernando Rodney. Tigers play the infield back. They'll gladly give up the run for an out. Here's a foul out of play. Peyton won't walk much. He doesn't strike out much. Generally puts the ball in play somewhere. And that's all the A's want right now. They want to break through and at least get on the scoreboard. Granderson will shade over toward right center. And Monroe in left will shade a little bit toward left center. Right-handed batter against the righty Zamaya. Man at third and one out, and the Tigers leading 5-0. There's a pitch low and outside. Fastball away. 1-1 on Peyton in a 5-0 game. Another 8:19 start Eastern time tomorrow. 5 o'clock locally. We're on the air tomorrow night at 7:50 on the Tigers radio network. 1-1 from Zamaya, ground ball, and it kicks off of Zamaya's shooter in. Picks it up, throws to first, got him! Oh, in the score comes Bradley. What a play by Brandon Inns. Zamaya's only reaction was to try to deflect it with his foot, and he deflected it right to in, who just nicked Peyton at first. The A's disagree, but it's two down and a run in, 5-1 Tigers.
Well, the ball was hit awfully hard and went into center field, but the big man Zamaya happened to just kick it over to Brandon, and quick as he is, he gunned to first, and Ken Maka out there to get a little argument going with the first base umpire, but he's going to lose it, but they do get on the board.
Peyton gets an RBI. Bradley scores. Base is empty. The first run of the night for the Oakland A's. Brandon slightly bobbled the ball, and we watch a replay, and it's, we've seen a couple. I think his foot was an inch off the base when he caught the ball.
He's out. Anyway, that's the main thing. He was called out.
Actually, we just saw one more replay that showed he was. I thought he was safe until that replay. Here's a fly ball deep left center field off the bat of Chavez. Way back and up against the wall. Granderson will leap and make the catch to take extra bases away from Chavez. And that's just the way things have been going for the Oakland A's tonight. Tigers have had the hard hit balls hit at their fielders, and they've stranded a lot of base runners. The A's get on the board, but after eight, it's the Tigers 5 and the A's 1 on the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network.
Hello, Tigers fans. This is Iron Mike, president of Detroit Metal Market. Everybody knows what I do. I'm the scrap metal guy. Does your company generate scrap metal? Do you wonder if you're getting all you can for your scrap metal? Maybe it's just time for a consultation so you'll know the market. If it's metal, I want it, and we pick up. Consulting, analysis, correct grading, and market prices. Remember, if you don't sell your metals to me, we both lose money. So call me at 877-IRON-MIKE or log on to 877-IRON-MIKE.com.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League pennants, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success, your success. For over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
Postseason suite packages are on sale now. Multi-game and individual game packages are available for ALCS and potential World Series home games at Comerica Park. Call 313-471-2222 now.
We have the hometown call of every inning of Tiger playoff baseball only on 1270 XYT, the sports station.
Ordonez will lead off. It's the top of the ninth inning, and the Tigers in game one of the American League Championship Series of the Oakland A's have a 5-1 lead. The Oakland A's, base runners in every inning. But A's batters tonight with runners in scoring position. This has been a problem with the A's all season long. Have gone 0-for-12 with men in scoring position tonight.
You know, Dan, even though they swept the Minnesota Twins, they did not do a good job with men in scoring position in that series either. So it's kind of coming, it's hanging on with their hitters into this series so far. It's only the first game, but this is a crazy game. For us to have a 5-1 lead with all the opportunities they had, and you look at the good defense we've had in the double plays, four double plays.
Now Ordonez facing Blanton takes a breaking ball off the plate, and Chavez smoked that ball to end the bottom of the eighth inning. Four good swings off of Joel Zamaya. Ordonez swings and taps one foul behind home plate.
Jones throwing in our pen.
Zito, Godin, Kennedy, Calero, and Blanton. That's been the pitchers used by Ken Maka tonight, the Oakland A's manager. Now the 1-1 pitch, swing and a ground ball foul past the A's dugout. 1-2. Ordonez is 1-for-4 tonight. An infield single with the bases loaded in the third scored the second run of the game. Brandon Inge got everything started with a line drive home run down the line and left off of Zito with two outs in the third. The hanging breaking ball is high and outside to make it 2-2. Tigers added one more in the third, three in the fourth. And they'll take a 5-1 lead at least to the bottom of the ninth. There's the breaking ball off the plate again. And Blanton, who walked the first batter he faced on four pitches, is now to a full count on Magler Ordonez. Guillen Rodriguez to follow here in the ninth. 5 runs, 11 hits, 1 error for the Tigers. Did not figure into the A's scoring. 1 run, 8 hits, and 1 big error for the A's. Breaking ball outside, and Blanton walks his second batter of the five he's faced for the second straight inning and leadoff walk.
Forgot to mention that other double play, another donation that boy Jack's Place is making out tonight. Jack's Place for Autism donated by Zuber Buick. So four double plays, four donations from Zuber Buick for Jack's Place for Autism.
And the pitching changes tonight have been brought to you by New Life. You can change your life today with New Life. Call 866-NULIFE3. Now Guillen at the plate, swing and a foul. A little tapper to the right of home plate. Carlos Guillen is 1-for-4 tonight. Terrific series against the Yankees, 8-for-14. And it used to be for a while the team's like turning him around to the right side, but Jim, now he's good from both sides. He's hitting with power from both sides, a lot of confidence from both sides.
Yeah, I think part of it is you don't hit from the right side a lot because of the lack of left-handed pitching. So all of a sudden he saw more left-handed pitching, got better and better at it.
There's a swing and a tap foul behind home plate. That's the thing with switch hitters. They need to see, especially those lefties, to get the right side going. But not too often both sides are going well, but they are right now for Carlos Guillen.
I tell you, everybody that asked me about our players, he's one of the guys you want to talk about. Carlos Guillen with his complete all-around play. His instincts are marvelous.
Now the pitch, swing and a miss. He got the fastball by him, and that one clocked at 95 miles an hour.
I think the gun was a little little off. I don't think that's in his territory.
I don't think so. First strikeout for Blanton.
And again, only the second Tiger to strike out tonight. That is impressive with the five walks to go with it.
You won't see that tally very often. Five walks,
no.
Two strikeouts,
no.
For Tigers batters.
No.
But I think very reflective of the quality of the at-bats we've seen in the five games of the postseason. Now Pudge at the plate, and he takes a fastball strike right at the belt. 2-for-4 for Pudge tonight. Home run leading off the fourth inning. And then he just took an outside pitch and dropped it into right field for a base hit his last time up. Swisher is holding with Ordonez at first. Breaking ball, swing and a miss, and Pudge down on the count. No balls, two strikes. Each time Blanton has walked a batter, he's come back and hardly even gone to a two-ball count on the next batters. Last inning, got Granderson, Polanco, and Santiago rather easily. Struck out Guillen on three pitches, now 0-2 on Pudge. The pitch, low and outside, didn't miss by much. Now Jones will come on to face the A's in the bottom of the ninth inning, and it'll be the bottom third of the order. But some pretty tough hitters in Swisher and Scudero especially, and then look for a pinch hitter for Jimenez. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Oh, he waved at the breaking ball down and away off the plate. Now back-to-back strikeouts for Joe Blanton after the leadoff walk.
Well, the good one was that Guillen was a good fastball to strike on, but that pitch wasn't even close to being a strike.
Top of the ninth inning today, brought to you by your Detroit area Chevy dealers. Chevy drives the Motor City, 5-1, Tigers with the lead. Trying to ensure that they will have at least a split of these first two games in Oakland. Now Monroe takes a strike right at the knees on the outside corner. And then tomorrow, Justin Verlander against Esteban Loaiza for the Oakland A's. The guy who's had the Tigers number, but remember they did have that one game where they knocked him out early in the game after three innings back in July. Now Monroe takes a pitch low and outside. One ball, one strike.
We saw him early in the year. He did not have his good fastball, and he felt that playing in the international games really threw him off. And they say the second half of the season, he got regained that some of that velocity that he had lost. He had more bite at the plate with his cutter.
and it was a much improved pitcher later on in the season.
And right after the Tigers knocked him around, he went on a roll.
Yeah.
I mean, he really was on a tear in August and September. Here's a pitch high. 2-1 on Craig Monroe. He's 0-3 plus a walk in this game. 11 hit attack plus 5 walks for the Tigers. Blanton, the starter, delivers. There's a fly ball to center field. Not very deep. Kotze will drift back, make the catch. Moving to his left, Monroe is out, and so are the Tigers. We head to the bottom of the ninth. Tigers have a 4-run lead, 5-1. This is the home of Detroit Tigers baseball.
America's number one sports morning show joins Detroit's number one sports station. Mike and Mike in the Morning comes to 1270 XYZ, the sports station. Morning 6 to 10.
Somebody's going to have to come to the table awfully hard to jump into this crew.
Followed by the Sports Inferno with Mike Valenti and Jerry Foster. Middays 10 to 2. The Big Show with Doug Karsh and Art Regner. Afternoons 2 to 6. The Tigers Spotlight with Scott the Gator Anderson. Evenings at 6. Only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
Ever hear of the Masons? Chances are, you know several Masons and aren't even aware of it. The truth is, Masons are everyday people. Business leaders, firefighters, dads, sons, even neighbors. And they all believe in the same things, like honor, integrity, and just doing the right thing. It all comes down to building a better world. That's what the Masons are really all about. Share the secret. MichiganMasons.org. Masons. Live better.
I'm back. I am the Ricola Mystery Cougher. If you hear me coughing and offer me a soothing, natural Ricola cough drop, you could win $1 million. And this year, I'm also coming to one lucky listener's home. Register at RicolaUSA.com for clues and official rules. And remember,
I could be a woman.
No purchase necessary. Game open for legal U.S. residents 18 years or older. Game runs October 9th to November 18th.
Does anyone have a
Ricola?
Terry Foster here. Don't miss Tiger Insider Tom Gage every Thursday during the playoffs on the Sports Inferno, midday 10 to 2, only on 1270 XYZ, the sports station.
Bottom of the ninth in Oakland, and the Tigers have a 5-1 lead. This crowd on their feet, making noise at the Coliseum, urging their A's to come from behind. Todd Jones will come out of the bullpen, and for the first time in 10 meetings with the Oakland A's this year, he will face Oakland A's hitters.
Well, he picked up his first career save in the postseason against the Yankees, and well, you look what he did over his last 34 outings. That's very impressive. 233 batting average, 18 saves. That was 35 innings and only 6 earned runs. And you marvel at his first 5 strikes. And only 11 walks and 28 strikeouts for this right-hander this year. And that's been a big part of what he does. The cutter, the two-seamer, the occasional breaking ball.
We saw him mow through the Yankees to preserve the Game 2 win. And as we mentioned in that game, he's done a better job against lefties because of the cutter. Very little extra base power. And Swisher, the switch batter, will bat from the left side. The first pitch is high and outside.
A rare first pitch ball.
Can't remember the last time that happened, especially to the first batter. Jones works from the stretch from the first base side of the rubber. Infield back. Granderson shades to right center. Swisher takes low. And it's a rare 2-0 count with Todd Jones on the mound. Swisher struck out twice against Nate Robertson, once with men at second and third in the fourth inning. Then he popped out his last time up against Fernando Rodney. Swisher, Scudero, and Jimenez, the scheduled batters. There's a fastball high, and 3-0 now on Nick Swisher.
Very rare occasion.
5 runs, 11 hits, 1 error for the Tigers. 1 run, 8 hits, 1 error for the A's. The next pitch is low, and I don't remember seeing that all year. A 4-pitch walk by Todd Jones to start an inning.
Well, just maybe sets up another double play for it.
So that makes it, 9 innings where the A's have had at least one batter every inning.
This has just been a crazy, crazy game, but we're leading. That's the main thing.
Marco Scudero grabs the bat. He has struck out, bounced into a double play, and then bounced out again. Now Pudge will come out to have a word with Todd Jones, pointing over toward first base. Scudero, very tough out. One of his big improvements, and one of the reasons Billy Beam was wondering if he'd really fit with the Oakland A's, early in his career, he really didn't work the count much. He wasn't a typical A's hitter, but he now does. There's a strike from Todd Jones. He drew a ton of walks this year, and he's got extra base power. And as the Tigers saw, home run power from time to time. Guillen will play behind Nick Swisher, the runner at first. Jones rocks into his motion, up and in on the right-hander hitting Scudero. Almost hit him. It's one ball, one strike. D'Angelo Jimenez, the switch batter, is in the on-deck circle. They've got some options on that bench if they want a pinch hit. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swinging a pop-up right side. Going into the outfield grass to make the catch behind first. Polanco for the first out of the ninth inning.
Well, that has been those two pitches, the cutter and the two-seamer, that he really didn't break out in the first part of the season. That has really, in my opinion, made him a heck of a closer, because the cutter goes away from a right-hander, the two-seamer comes in, and he absolutely stalled him off with the two-seamer.
Bottom of the ninth inning brought to you by Century 21. Century 21, agents of change. D'Angelo Jimenez, 1-for-3 tonight, takes a strike. Now he's getting back into that good rhythm. Starts him off with a fastball at the knees. Jimenez singled in his middle at bat. He has struck out and flied to right. 5-1, Tigers with the lead, trying to close it out in the bottom of the ninth inning. Next pitch, low and inside. Another switch batter batting lefty against the righty Todd Jones. Inge about even with the base at third. Off the line, middle of the infield, looking for something on the ground. The outfield is shallow. They play Jimenez batting left-handed to go the opposite way. Jones takes a long look in. Into his motion, he delivers. Ground ball to second base on a high chop. Polanco has it, looks to second, throws to first instead. They'll get the batter, Jimenez. He didn't want to take a chance on not getting Swisher at second base on the slow chopper. So Swisher now at second with two outs in the ninth.
Good job by Todd Jones. A little easy ground ball, and the instincts of Placido Polanco knowing that run means nothing. I'll get the shore out at first base, and that's the right way to play it.
Two down. The A's are down to their last out. Jason Kendall has reached four times tonight. Two walks, a single, then he reached on an error his last time up, but then was erased on a double play. Tough out. He had a terrific second half, hit .326 in the second half, and he hits well in his home ballpark. The first pitch, strike one. So after walking the leadoff man Swisher on four pitches, he has thrown strike one to each of the next three batters. Swisher at second, two down in the ninth. Infield back, the outfield shallow. Granderson shades to right center. The strike one pitch, swinging a high fly ball to right. This should do it. Back goes Ordonez, two steps, pounds the glove, makes the catch, and the Tigers take game one of the American League Championship Series. Nate Robertson, Fernando Rodney, Joel Zamaya, and Todd Jones worked in and out of trouble throughout the night, but they get the job done with big pitches when it mattered. Our final score in Oakland, the Tigers 5 and the Oakland A's 1.
The Detroit Tigers have a long tradition of greatness. 9 American League titles, 4 World Series championships, and 14 Hall of Famers. Great players, great teams, great moments. Comerica Bank is proud to have its name on the ballpark of another truly great team, the 2006 Detroit Tigers. Like this year's Tigers, we understand the importance of teamwork, of coming together, combining our skills, and working towards a goal to achieve success, your success. For over
over 150 years, we've been helping people reach their goals. You can count on Comerica to provide the expertise, guidance, and financial resources you need. And like the Tigers, we work hard to be the best. Comerica Bank is proud to support the Detroit Tigers as they make their playoff run. Here's to greatness, the past, the present, and the future. Go get them, Tigers. Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Member FDIC.
And now, another Comcast Consumer Update.
I'm here with the fastest pitcher in the league, Detroit's own Joel Zamaya, known for his blazing 103-mile-an-hour fastball.
Thanks, but that's still not as fast as Comcast high-speed internet.
Well, Comcast high-speed internet is true high-speed, and now with Power Boost, it's even faster.
What?
You can download photos, files, music, and more faster than ever.
Mm-hmm.
Power Boost is an extra surge of power that kicks in for downloading up to twice as fast.
That's like pitching 206 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Is the competition that fast?
Well, let's just say they only throw slow curveballs.
Well, where do I sign with Comcast?
Just call 1-888-COMCAST to get Comcast high-speed internet for $19.99 a month for 4 months.
This has been a Comcast Consumer Update.
New customers only. After promotion, standard rate supply, installation, taxes, and franchise fees extra. Actual speeds may vary. Power Boost speed claims and references are for downloads only and are available with 6 meg and 8 meg speed plans. Limited time offer. Other restrictions apply.
Is the 1270 XYT Detroit Tigers Radio Network. Now the Detroit Tigers postgame show. Brought to you by Comerica Bank. We listen, we understand, we make it work. Now back to Dan Dickerson and Jim Bryce.
And finally, brought to you by Panasonic ELS Surround. Anything but stereotypical. The Tigers make it four straight wins in the postseason. Open the American League Championship Series with an impressive 5-1 win over the Oakland A's, picking right up where they left off against the New York Yankees. Carlos Guillen joins us now down in that Tigers dugout after a 1-for-5 night, but he also had to shift positions from shortstop over to first.
Well, you know, he's a complete player, and Carlos, first of all, congratulations, but how important was it for Brandon Inns to get that home run in the third inning after Zito looked like he had good stuff and set down 8 in a row?
It was very important. You know, we start up in the scoreboard by home run to Brandon Inns, and you know, we got nine players. You know, we got nine players that can hit. We have pretty good defense, good pitching, but nice shot by Ney. You know, this is a team, you know. Everybody play together. We play nine hard innings every day.
Well, the name of the game, we mentioned coming in that the Oakland A's led the American League in hitting in the double plays with 170. Our infield tonight pulled off four double plays. Got to make you feel good.
Yeah, you got nine players out there. You know, they give you more, you know, more comfortable to the pitch. You know, they throw strikes, they're going to hit the ball, you know, any ground ball, you can make double plays. And that's the way, you know, we win games. You know, when the pitcher throws strikes, they're going to win a lot of games.
Carlos, what are you noticing about the postseason and the at-bats that you're seeing from yourself and your teammates? It just seems we're seeing very consistent at-bats and making sure that if you score early, you're still trying to add on runs late.
Yeah, that's how I go, you know, having nice at-bat, constantly every at-bat, you know, you got four, at least four times you go over there trying to get a hit, trying to hit the ball hard, put the ball in play. That way you put more pressure on the defense, you know.
Do you feel like the win over the Yankees, especially the way you finished that series, helped you with your confidence coming into this series? Did you take a lot of confidence because of that?
Yeah, a little bit, you know, but we have to play the same way we play against Kansas City, against the Yankees, against Oakland A's. We have the same play we've been playing the whole year. That's the way we want to be consistent, you know.
Well, you've been consistent all year and a great start in the postseason. Go ahead and enjoy this victory. Let's get ready to make it 2 in a row tomorrow night.
Yeah.
William, my friend.
Thank you, Carlos.
You're welcome.
All right, Carlos Guillen, the Tigers All-Stars shortstop, and tonight, first baseman. And as he said before we took the air, the squibber off the end of the bat of Jason Kendall had a little hot coming into his glove. Because really, Jim, if you watch the replay, he did everything right.
Oh, yeah.
No, he got in position. He was right next to the bag, and the ball just kicked off the heel of his glove.
Anytime you hit a ball off the end of the bat, it has a lot of spin to it. And the best thing would have been to step on it.
And on the very next play, of course, he started the 3-6-1 inning-ending double play.
Four double plays, boy.
Boy, that was the theme of the night, big pitches, and you really do go back to that, Jim. I'm sure the A's will take out of this. Well, we had a lot of base runners. We just missed our chances, but we look at it the other way tonight. That really, I mean, Nate Robertson made some terrific pitches in dangerous situations.
Well, you always tip your hat to the pitcher to get the ground ball, number one, You know, so our pitchers did that tonight. But that fourth inning when they had two on with nobody out and he struck out Chavez, Switcher, and Scudero, that was big time. Then they had to be talking to themselves after that inning and just couldn't get anything going. And then they finally got a run in the eighth, and that was it.
Tigers win it by the final of 5-1. And the Tigers now with a best-of-seven series 1-0 lead over the Oakland A's in the best-of-seven series, the first two games in Oakland. And as you said, a chance to go up 2-0 going back home. And Justin Verlander, the only Tigers starter to make three starts against the A's this year, is on the mound for the Tigers tomorrow. And there was something to like about each and every one of his three starts against the Oakland A's, including two here in Oakland. We have continuing post-game coverage. 5-1, Tigers with the win in Game 1. Stay with us. More coming up after this on the Detroit Tigers Radio Network.